Live from inside that giant American flag hanging behind General Patton, it's the Grandma's Virginity Podcast, episode 27. This time on the show, in an uncharacteristically earnest moment, Justin ponders the origins of a serious epidemic.
Aliens gave us AIDS!
Hey! Aliens gave us AIDS! Yo!
Ryan's grandfather recounts thrilling tales from World War II.
So wait, did you guys storm this munitions dump and there's still Nazis that didn't escape yet?
No, I didn't storm shit.
And suffers through his grandson's comedic sensibilities.
Oh. Did he operate in a submarine that had a screen door in the Army?
Hey, take it easy.
No, you're passing those kind of jokes?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Hello.
And Justin's.
I am the farting German soldier.
Okay. Well, what are you here for?
All that and a big tucket more.
How do I start it?
What
do
I say? Hey, everybody.
Okay. Hey, everybody. Welcome to episode 27 of the Grandma's Virginity Podcast.
Yeah.
I'm Justin Roiland. With me is Ryan Ridley.
Hey.
And Jackie Buscarino.
Hello.
And our equipment is as faulty as ever this week. I'm going to be fighting with the levels all episode long.
Well, our equipment is faulty, but how is everyone's personal lives? On a scale of 1 to 10, Jackie.
What, 10 being really good?
10 being great.
I would say 1.
Justin.
I'm going to give it a 7.
Oh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Wow, what happened?
What do you mean what happened?
What happened? Why are you a 7?
Maybe I'm an 8. I don't know.
Ooh, you keep going up. Why don't you give that extra point to Jackie so she can be a 2.
Okay.
And you can still be a 7.
Okay.
What
there
about,
you go,
what
Jackie.
Number are you, Ryan?
I'm about a 7, yeah.
Oh, you guys are doing really well this week.
Well, it's not that I'm doing any better. I'm just happy.
Are you talking about like the week on the whole, or
just, you know, right
today
now,
specifically?
Justin, you know, there's only the moment. You know,
yeah.
We can only There's only the moment.
Wait,
I believe that's from the power of now.
Yeah, yeah, but.
Oh, yeah, your mom told me I need to read that book.
I heard that Eckhart Tolle was coming to visit.
Oh, wait, yeah, I heard.
Oh, wait.
No. He's just sitting here.
Wait, oh, hold on. Let me get the door. Hello?
Hello, Justin.
Oh, who is this?
Is this the author?
This is, yes, Jackie. My name is Eckhart Tolle.
Have you been on Oprah Winfrey?
Of course.
Did she endorse this book?
Of course.
For reals?
So,
yes, Miss Winfrey understood that the power of now is the way to live and the way to take our civilization into
me.
The next millennium.
Help me.
Okay.
Huh?
Help me get into the now. I'm very much in my own thoughts right now, Eckhart.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Help me.
You think about the past,
uh-huh.
All the
and
friends
the
and women who've betrayed you.
Sure.
And you imagine that being your affecting your present.
Yeah.
Even though it's got nothing to do with your present.
Yeah. So help me.
What?
What do I do?
Is this really what his message is?
Yes.
What do I do, Eckhart Tolle? What do I do?
You just stop thinking about all that bullshit from the past.
Okay.
And you stop having dark fantasies about the future.
Uh-huh.
Neither of those things are real. All that there is the present.
Okay. So here, let me try that real quick.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Whoa.
It worked? Ooh,
like a weight
has
been lifted.
All there is now, right now. This
wow.
Moment.
Mm. I feel good.
This horrible impression
and,
is all there is.
And what is bothering you right now?
Jackie, where are you right now?
What?
Where are you right now?
Tell
me what's going on in your mind.
Sadness.
There's
darkness.
There's no such thing as sadness and darkness. They're mere illusions.
So this is the latest craze, is this Power of Now book.
Yes.
Kind of like The Secret.
Yes. I mean, no.
Fuck
it's
that
nothing
shit.
Like, it's nothing like The Secret. The Secret is a bunch of hokum.
Yeah.
Fuck that shit.
Well, it's
chapter 9
says. Your mom suggested it. I should read it, but I probably won't. You know what I mean?
She's a smart woman. She raises Rottweilers and Justin Roiland. She knows what she's doing, obviously.
Here's the thing. It's
she knows it's a good, how a person it's a
good,
should be.
It's a good thing to read. If you're able to let it penetrate into your mind, but it's hard. I don't know.
Like a long, it makes hard
sense. You'll read it and you'll be like,
of
oh,
course,
okay.
I think lots of things make sense, like talking to therapists, reading stuff, going out, going on hikes. It all makes sense, but it doesn't make me feel any better.
You can also get the special tea. It's the Power of Now tea. If you drink it, it helps you be in the now more.
How much is that, Eckhart?
Is it poisonous?
$60 a box.
Okay, and how many bags is in the box?
One.
All right.
Thank you.
As soon as
we're
done,
going to read that book right away.
As soon as we're done, I'll go pick up some tea.
Is this a polite way of telling me to leave?
Yes.
Eckhart, we need you to leave now. You're really bumming us
Goodbye.
Out.
Goodbye.
Oh.
Yeah, there we go.
That's a little bit of a double beat.
Oh, my God. All right. So, anyways.
Oh, I'm going to read that book, Justin, because it seems to be doing wonders on you. You're an eight.
You know, I feel, I don't know. I'm all right.
Well, why don't we talk about who we're going to have on the show today?
Yeah.
A little bit.
Yay.
My grandfather.
What's his first name? I never.
Bert.
Oh.
He's 89 years young.
Any relation to Ernie? Huh? Get it? I mean, not get it. I mean, see how that works?
I mean, that's a joke.
See how that makes sense?
He was fought in World War II.
Yay!
He has known me since I was a kid.
No!
Interesting.
He is a font of old school wisdom.
Oh!
Is he a funny guy?
Wow.
Is he funny?
We'll see. You know what? He can be shy, so I don't know how this is going to go. He could be really shy. He could be really clammed up.
How old is he again?
89.
Whoa. Wow. Damn, 89.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
but he's still got his wits about him.
Yeah.
And
sharp
as attack. Hopefully we can draw that out. And if we don't, it'll be a short record.
It'll be fine.
What can you say?
I got a lot of questions for him.
Okay.
So, Jackie, is there anything besides your job? Anything in your life? Any new stories? I heard you were at Jumbo's Clown Room.
Yeah.
Why?
That was fun.
Why?
People from work went there. And I've never been there before, but I was excited because
Did it make you feel better about your own looks?
No, I mean, I was actually disappointed because the girls were, I had heard, you
it's
know,
a strip
these
club.
Well, it's not even really, they just wear like unders and bra and underwears.
And red, and red noses.
They don't show their boobs and butts and vaginas, really. I mean, but there's pole dancing and stuff. Mm-hmm. I thought that the girls were going to be tore up. Like, I thought it
from
was going to be
up.
Electrical tape on their boobs and just like crazy punk rock girls.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And it wasn't.
No?
No.
But they're still pretty skanky, right?
No. I mean, I thought they looked tough. Like, some of them looked tough. One was beautiful. I mean, she could get a job at Spearmint Rhino. I don't know why.
Well, Spearmint Rhino, she's got to, you know,
show her
pull back her vagina lips you know, be filthy.
Yeah.
At Jumbo's Clown Room, she just has to walk on a filthy carpet.
Yeah. It is dirty.
She could get a job at one of those places with the peep show booths.
Yeah.
I guess. I don't know. And the songs that they picked were disappointing. My image of it, I had a lot of fun. But
is this the first time you've ever been to a strip club?
Yeah.
I've never been either.
To a strip club?
Never been.
Really?
I've never been to a strip club. I've only been inside a strip club
to
as a PA.
To use the bathroom. I went in to use the bathroom.
Oh. I worked inside of a strip club for a day on a shoot. A game show that I was a production assistant on.
So what do you think, Jackie? What did you come away with?
And there were no strippers inside.
What do you mean?
I don't know.
I just thought to myself, if I worked at Jumbo's Clown Room,
I'd be showing my titties off.
No, I would be going, like, I'd pick some type of crazy, I mean, I was talking about this, like, pick some punk rock songs and go up there and just, like,
take a shit on the carpet.
No, it was very tame,
I'd
guess.
Shock
I don't
people.
I don't know. I just thought it was just tame.
Wear the American flag as a diaper.
They use the
pee in it.
They reuse like the same routine kind of over and over again because it's all these girls sort of in a round robin. You get your song, you go, and you just keep going, and they keep just
next
repeating
up,
the
it's
same
round robin.
Routine.
What would people just sit there in a row watching like a
theater?
Yeah,
there's a
like
front row. I sat in the front row, and you have to give them dollars. You're supposed to. It's a 2-drink minimum, and then if you're in the front, then you better be giving dollars. And it was just like, after a while, it was just like, Okay, there was one really cool lady that was like a mom.
Uh-huh.
Stage? Yeah, but and
with
she
her
was
kids?
Older.
You could
no.
tell by her stretch marks.
No, she told me.
You tell by the baby, baby backpack, the front. What are those called where
a
the
papoose?
Baby sits in the front?
Bjorn?
Yeah.
No,
Bjorn.
She told me because like she got, I was, they
put
liked
in
me
mouth.
In the front. Like they put the hat on me and like uh-huh. did
grab
that kind
the dollar,
of stuff.
Sweetie.
And I'm trying to tell it, but forget
sorry,
it.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
No, Jackie.
No, we're just
please.
We're just making
oh, Jackie.
Jokes.
Oh, Jackie.
I'm so tired.
Jackie, do you want some coffee? Do you want a little 24-hour energy
yes.
juice?
No,
do
I want coffee.
Do you want a
coffee.
Heath bar? I mean, a
no,
coffee
thank you.
Bar?
Yeah, Ryan brought oh, me a cool. score bar. That
oh.
was good.
Oh, he,
I just devoured
he's basically
it.
Saying, you know, oh, do, what more can I do for you?
It's,
yeah.
It's be good. It's like, I should have given you after. Like, I should, like, right now when you just got bummed out about me and Justin talking over, I should have, like, thrown
then
you, like, a score bar, like a seal.
Yeah.
Like, oh. come on, Jackie, just be cool.
All right, well,
cool
anyways,
it.
Continue. Was
treat.
The lady there with the baby or not?
Oh, no, but she, I was like, oh, I like your hat. And she's like, thanks, it's my daughter's. And I was like, oh.
Oh, Jesus. Keep that, isn't that? Okay, yeah, that's not...
How are the gentlemen at the
there
gentlemen's
were a
club?
Lot of lesbians there, too, which was
oh,
another,
like
two
show?
Bars in a row. Like, first with dangerous lesbians, uh-huh. whatever,
and then
last
hot
week.
Ones.
No, this one was just,
fertile.
Like, young, just
ready
a ton
to go.
Of lesbian couples there.
Mm-hmm. Ready
lipstick,
to mingle.
Or...
Just more like bike messenger looking.
Bike messenger looking.
Do you know what that
looking?
Oh, like San Francisco no. bike messengers?
Like
of.
Scars
short,
and...
kind
of dyed hair with,
broken
like,
arms.
Earrings, like, and nose rings.
Spiky
and
black
no,
hair.
No, no, they're cuter than that. They're more hip. They look like Silver Lake bike messengers.
Would me and Justin try to hit on them?
Maybe if
or
they
we
were
no, they were lesbians.
If they weren't with their girlfriends, you probably mm-hmm. no. Actually,
no.
You may, maybe Ryan, not Justin. They're
yeah,
too
no,
they're
you.
Too scraggly for Justin.
Yeah, no,
oh, you
taste.
Think that my taste leans towards the scraggly?
I think
like
your taste is anything.
I like them girly. I like them girly
anything.
And wily and rancid.
Anything I've got
the
standards.
Band.
I've got
yeah.
taste.
Well, we'll talk about that.
Okay.
Later.
Speaking
I,
of which,
oh, go ahead.
Are we going to talk about the same thing?
Maybe.
Can we? I want to ask. Me and Justin were discussing something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we want to ask you,
and,
Jackie.
And mm-hmm. we're trying now to like basically get people interested in something else besides the age old. Is it cool to fart and poop in front of your lover?
Oh, right,
yeah, that
right.
seems
that
to
seems
be,
to be the number one thing that really resonates.
Yeah,
with people.
It's like, yeah, come on, guys.
I know. Look
yeah,
what
move
I started.
On, you know,
can
yeah.
we, can we put that one to in its grave?
So now we want to talk about something else.
Yeah,
you
baby.
Want your opinion on it. I was talking oh, yeah. to a woman the mm-hmm. other day, and she was telling me about this guy who was. Clearly hitting on her.
Mm-hmm.
Like she's like, oh, you know,
like working it, working
yeah,
it to
like,
fuck.
Oh,
he is trying to get in her
yeah.
pants,
yeah. and it's so obvious for me as a guy. Like,
yeah.
she's like, oh no, he's just, we just, he just wants to be friends. I'm like, really?
He's just being nice.
You just met him last week, and now he's always calling you and texting you, inviting you things because he just really thinks
wants
your personality
buddies.
Is great.
Yeah. And he's a
yeah.
straight,
needless to say,
yeah.
guy. You
okay.
know, single.
And so me and Justin start talking about this, and I really, as I was talking to this person, I was getting like. Angry, but you know, I'm not being a dick, but I'm just like, I'm putting it in perspective. I'm like, you know what? If a girl that I just met, and I had this happen to me like a year ago, like, girl I just met all of a sudden is like emailing me and offering me all these things, inviting me all these things. I'm like,
you would think
she's
yeah.
trying to, she's coming on to me.
Yeah.
She wants me to date her.
Yeah.
She doesn't,
right.
she's not a friend of mine.
Right.
Yes.
I have female friends, but like, not, those are friendships that are, you know, like Jackie. Like, I didn't just meet Jackie. You know what I
yeah,
mean?
Yeah. yeah.
Like,
yeah.
So, anyway, so she's going. So she got bummed out. She's like, oh, she's such a bummer to think about that. And then me and Justin are talking about, is she purpose? Are these women, because I've met so many women that say this about
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, it's every girl I know see. Has no idea that
that's
when a
lie.
Guy is like
that's a fucking
hardcore
okay,
coming
thank
onto
you.
Them.
A
fucking
thank you.
Lie.
Yes, yes. So that's what Justin has theory. Either they're
but
so naive.
But you say no. They're not naive. But you say no because you don't want to seem like maybe that you kind of like that attention. So you just say, oh, he doesn't like me.
Yeah.
I do it too as a defense.
Oh.
More as a defense thing
that's
of just you don't want to sound like an asshole. By being like, yeah, he fucking's hitting on me and I don't like him. And you don't want to seem that way because maybe that guy is nice.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean? And so you don't want to completely be a bitch.
But if I'm saying to you as someone who may or may not have a romantic relationship with you, so may or may not be getting a little like jealous or defensive, like going like, no, he's... Oh, he wants you to go out with him again? He asked you again to go out with him this weekend.
Yeah,
yeah he's hitting
when
on you.
When
no,
coming, okay,
he just
okay,
wants
wait,
to be
here's
a friend.
Two situations too. No, no, no.
Yeah.
That's the thing too. And if it's this girl whom I think probably you're talking about, maybe it's a game. It's a psychological warfare game.
Against me?
Oh, fuck yeah.
Well, hold on.
But I want to say this. When guys are soliciting like, hey, do you want to hang out? You want to go to this bar? Blah, 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 blah. And if they're straight, they want to fuck you.
Mm-hmm.
Girls, I know me as a girl, I become obsessed about people. They can mm-hmm. be a boy, they can be a girl. Mm. I have to be careful with boys because it would come across that I'm trying to. But I become, like I said, equal. I get excited about a person,
so
boy or girl.
You could meet somebody.
And I'm like, do you want to hang out? Do you want, let's do this. Let's whatever. But I have to, you have to walk a line when it comes to guys because they automatically think she's into me.
In previous relationships I've had, I've been with girls who almost every single one of them, every single, I want to say, I have a horrible memory, but I know that this has happened a bunch where I'm with a girl and then some guy is like just really aggressively trying to hang out with her, inviting her over at night, like come hang out at my house tonight. It's midnight. And dude's like, and then I'm like, he's trying to get in your pants. He wants to fuck you.
Yes.
And then the girl's like, no way. No,
no
way.
They know. They know. The girl knows.
Oh, my God. He would you're being crazy. No way.
Yeah, no.
No way. I'm like, are you? It's either they're fucking.
Is there no common sense?
Yeah.
Well, this is the hard thing, too, is as a girl, I suppose, who has.
It's like the girl went into Mike Tyson's hotel room. Come on.
A lot of guy friends. You know, that's always a hard thing, too, because really, I think it's difficult for boys and girls to have, like, close friendships or whatever, where, like, you know, you have a pal that you go, I go to the movies. Like, say if you have a boyfriend, but then you have this friend that you go to the movies with every week who's a guy, and you're like, we're just friends. That's a fine line, too. Maybe if it's some childhood guy friend or I don't know. Do you know what I mean? Where I just think if that girl went to the movies that one night with the friend and was like, do you want to have sex? That guy would be like, yes. And that's kind of what he was waiting for this whole time for movie night.
Yes.
But then I feel like, for me anyways, like with using you guys as an example, I don't feel like if I hung out with you guys, like that you guys want to fuck me.
Well, obviously.
Yeah, no.
But so I think it's there's a little different, bit of a, there's varying degrees. So sometimes girls can be friends with guys.
Sorry, I just got a little nauseous for a second.
Shut up. I don't know. It just depends on the person. I don't know. But I do think that girls know exactly when boys are.
That's what I'm saying. The whole point is, of course, you know, we've known each other for like almost a year or something. So obviously, but it's like a new friend, a guy she just met. Wants to hang out with her all the time.
Yeah,
what a friendship is being formed.
Or she's going out with him already.
No.
Hey, take it easy, demon.
Yeah, whoa,
what?
Take it easy.
Take it easy, demon.
Well, does she hang out with him?
Maybe, sometimes.
Demon.
Yeah, she's...
Demon.
She's wanting to have two... What is it? Two in the hand, two in the basket. I don't know, something like that.
Two in the basket, one in the tree.
Wants to see how is it going to work out with this new friend. Uh-huh. And then if it works out and she ends up liking him, then she hasn't wasted any time and she still has another guy on the back.
All right, okay.
That's smart.
To evil thought.
No,
it's true.
I'm not saying she's
fucking
so...
true.
Look, Justin, you know, it's complicated.
Well, look,
I
don't know.
I'm not saying she's so wrong and I'm not saying that's not a terrible plan to have.
Yeah, you know,
woman's
you're right.
Got to protect herself.
Yeah, you're right.
You know?
You're right. You're right.
I guess
you got to have all your bases covered. Don't put
what
your
you
eggs
doing,
in
Jackie?
One basket.
I'm trying to refresh my news stuff, so I just remembered
something. Oh, boy, that's right, which is coming up.
Did you guys see, well, Justin did see this, about the Jerusalem UFOs?
What?
Oh, I don't know a lot about it. I just saw the video of
it. So in Jerusalem, there was, my friend sent me this email, like this, as if it was 100% real, of course.
Yeah.
And it was three YouTube videos that were all from the same UFO sighting over Jerusalem, over the Temple on the Mount.
Uh-huh.
The gold dome, you know,
And then the lights zoom down.
It's like this wall of light hovering, and there's three different clips, and they're all from three different angles, and one's like American tourists, like, oh my God, what the hell's that?
Oh,
and
I only saw
like
one.
Hebrew, like Israelis going like, good Hebrew, yeah. And then the other one is from like French tourists.
Oh, I got a story
like
about a Jew for you.
Okay, well, hold on. Let him finish. Go ahead. Where is this going? What happens?
Well, no, the point is that
it's real.
It's like pretty sophisticated, but of course, I looked it up and I just like put Jerusalem UFO hoax and like right away it was like, of course it's a fucking
hoax. Well,
yeah.
I mean, of course all the skeptics are going to start pouncing on it.
Oh,
it's real, Ryan. No. What it is it's a really impressive marketing campaign for an upcoming video game.
Are you serious?
No. I mean,
so
probably.
What is it?
Probably.
Well, what is
probably.
It? So what is it?
It's a hoax.
But how did they do the hoax is what I want to know.
Oh, I mean, they just had three different people film the same spot and they had some savant.
But
they had an alien help.
No. Yeah, somebody, was it done like, what am I trying
with
to
magic?
Say? Not CG, I'm just,
composite.
You know, composited. Or was it? It was.
It's something like
that. Well, no,
that.
Of course. Yeah. No, it was all
but
done in
the
computer.
But then I go back and forth because then like, what happens is you read the people who are defending it, who are saying it's not a hoax, they're going like, oh, yeah, I see the government PR campaign is already out there trying to make it look like it's, you know, it's a hoax. Yeah. And I'm like, well, what if that's right? What if, like, what if there's are people who go out and they, you know, purposely kind of write these hoaxing things?
Well, it wouldn't be hard. I mean, it's such an absurd concept, and it's such so taboo. It's like back, I mean, this is, believe me when I say I don't, it's not exactly like this because this is very different, but it's like back in the olden times when people said the world is round and everyone was like, fucking burn that guy. It's fucking, the world's flat. Like, fuck you. I mean, and I just mean in the sense that, you know, it's taboo. It's like the aliens are here. Like if physicists or, you know, scientists say that they believe in UFOs and aliens, they're immediately like blacklisted and shunned and like, you know, all right, cuckoo brains. You know what I mean? Get out of here. But, I mean, in all fairness, I mean, it's, I could see why. I mean, it's fucking insane to think. I mean, you know.
I just think, who cares? What if there are, if there aren't, what does it matter?
Well, you want to know my theory about it?
What does it matter?
I have a theory.
What does it matter? It doesn't affect me. I still have a bad life and I'm sad.
Well, you know what's,
what if the aliens could come down and make your life better?
They won't.
They won't, though.
Do you want to know what they'll do?
What?
Everyone says, like, oh, the fucking aliens, like all these movies, like L.A. Skyline, and then the new one, Battle for L.A. or whatever it's called, where the aliens come down and like fucking blow up buildings and try to kill every human on the world so they can, like, you know, colonize Earth and take over the resources. Mm-hmm. Okay, if aliens wanted to do that, if they're intelligent and capable, intelligent enough and powerful enough to be able to travel the vast distances of space.
Why would they come here?
No. Not why would they come here. Of course they would come here because we've got a giant planet.
Because of the Grand Canyon and Niagara
Falls. No, we have water. We have all these resources that they could.
They don't need it.
You don't. Okay. My point being, I could see us in 3,000 years needing it.
Right.
And having to find a planet and go colonize. So I could see that being a possibility. But if they have the technology to do that and to like skip across fucking light year, like billions of light years of space to get to us, then they're going to have the technology to abduct a human, reverse engineer their biological fucking DNA to come up with some sort of virus that they can then plant across the world that would wipe us out.
AIDS! The aliens gave us AIDS!
You're making it so complicated.
It's all about AIDS! AIDS!
Aliens gave us AIDS!
AIDS!
It's all about AIDS!
Yo!
Aliens gave us AIDS!
Hey! Aliens gave us AIDS! Yo! Hey, yo! My name is Michael! Aliens gave us AIDS! Hey! My name is Michael Johnson! Aliens gave us AIDS!
Hey!
Hey, yo! I'm Michael Smith! Aliens gave us AIDS.
Oh, my name's Bobby Jones.
Aliens gave us AIDS. That's a great song.
In 1962.
Hey.
They came down from the ships.
That's right.
They put it in a monkey.
Aliens gave us AIDS.
Hey, aliens gave us AIDS.
Hey, I know a...
so loud right now, you guys.
I'm sorry, Jackie.
I like your story, though. But I think aliens don't give a shit.
Aliens gave us AIDS,
no,
Jackie.
Well, I do believe that. I do believe aliens gave us AIDS.
Thank you.
But I will say, like, aliens, if there is a life form out there, we are so insignificant.
Can I just tell you really quick? Can I just tell you really quick?
They don't care
about Earth.
Cut
to the alien spaceship right now. Zimballs.
Yes, sir.
AIDS that we created not working as fast as we had hoped.
Yeah, our projections were 6 months.
Yeah,
that was 30 years ago.
I think we might need to develop something new.
Okay. Well, that's a bad pitch being.
Something that when they put their penis near the other one's vagina or butthole, it immediate death. No, none of this, you know, long-term... That medicine can help.
Yeah, who came up with the long term, by the way? Who's trying to use
that? Who was that? That was me. Sorry about that. I just thought, you know.
We were just talking about this. You can live forever with AIDS.
Yeah, exactly, Zimball. All right.
You are going to do the introduction.
Okay.
Well, you know, we don't even need one. We can just, you know.
Are you recording?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So he was in a real war. As opposed to your dad.
Yeah.
Hey, sashimi.
Jackie, how do you feel about that?
About what?
World War II versus Vietnam.
Well, when I was telling, because he was asking, hey, you know, your dad was in Vietnam, but I was saying his dad didn't really see any action.
Uh-huh.
He was an officer.
All right, well, we're here.
But how do I feel about
Vietnam versus World War II.
Completely
different. What's the cooler war?
No, I can't pick. You know they're both my favorite.
World War II is the cooler one.
I would pick World War II.
I know.
Do you know Bert dressed up as a Nazi?
I know.
Hold on.
We'll get to that. We're here with my grandfather.
No.
Maybe there's someone else who wants to show up first.
No, not yet.
Not so soon.
We're here with my grandfather.
Yeah.
World War II veteran.
Yeah.
The Fuhrer.
was that his nickname? The Fuhrer?
Do you have a picture of that when you played dress up?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, fine. Papa, why don't you tell the story?
Well, take us back. It was the year 19... what year was that?
What years were you?
That had to be 1944.
Uh-huh.
44.
Yeah, when I was in Germany.
Yeah.
And I took over a Gestapo headquarters.
Whoa. No, seriously.
From Indiana Jones.
Yeah, I get it.
They had the crystal skull. No.
I don't know if I have any pictures left of
no,
that.
No, you used to have a picture.
But in this headquarters, they had German Gestapo uniforms. So the guy that I had working with me, we put on two uniforms, and we were standing next to our Jeep,
mm-hmm.
which had a, we were a bomb disposal squad, and we're standing next to the Jeep, and we took a picture.
Dressed as Nazis.
Yeah.
During World War II.
Yeah, wow. This is during the war. Yeah.
It's a bit, right?
Yeah.
That's great.
I mean, it's meant for fun. Look at us. We're dressed as Nazis.
Yeah.
I'm lucky that the infantry didn't come by when I had that on.
Yeah.
You can't explain.
It would have been bad.
No.
It would have been bad. Yeah, right.
No, you don't understand.
Not kosher.
And was that, I mean, like, what would have happened if you're not even allowed to put on the enemy uniform, right?
No.
So you were doing this as a joke? You dressed up not to go undercover. You were just putting it on just as a bit?
Just for fun.
Well, you know.
For the photo.
When we took over this Gestapo headquarters, in fact, some of the coffee was still warm there. And they had some
shots. The hats were still spinning.
How did you take them? How'd you overtake them? Were you
they got the hell out of there.
They knew.
They knew to get away. So there wasn't shots fired or anything. They knew to get out.
By this time, they were gone.
Yeah.
Yeah. They knew the Allies were coming.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. So you were cross-military dressed.
But if you want some action stories, Jackie, my papa once... interrogated a Nazi soldier.
Yeah, that's what you were saying. He put a gun in his mouth.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. That's
how did you get to that point where you captured him, and what information were you trying to extract?
It was a colonel, a Gestapo colonel,
Colonel Klink, right?
No, I don't
Colonel
know
Mustard with the candlestick.
But you know, he was a colonel, and. I got this guy, and I was interrogating him, and I stuck a pistol in his mouth.
Yeah.
What kind of pistol?
.45?
A Luger.
Yeah, .45. No, a Luger's German.
Oh, I don't know.
No, well, yeah, but we took over the...
Yeah, so it could have been a... That's true.
I had Lugers, I had... also, P-38s was
in. Do you know those, Jackie?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
A great pistol.
I do.
Yeah. I had a lot of P-38s.
Uh-huh.
In fact, when we took over these factories, I assembled guns and used to sell them to the Army.
Uh-huh. What do you mean, sell them to the Army?
Oh, not to the Army. To the guys that were in the Army.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Had to make a living.
Wait a minute. Is that illegal?
You couldn't. Well,
that's
no,
a war
that's
crime.
That's how you make money.
He was running his own private enterprise
really?
During the war.
You couldn't make a living at $40 a month.
That's what the Army paid?
Yeah. Then I think it went up to about 80.
Wait, so that's pretty good. Wait, so you took the German weapons and sold them to American soldiers?
As souvenirs.
No, he assembled them. No, huh? I did. I assembled them. We made them.
Uh-huh. You took over the Luger
plant. We took over a Luger or a Walther factory
that
made the P-38s and Lugers.
Wow.
And what if the U.S. Army knew that you're doing that?
Well, didn't they?
Who cares?
Didn't they?
No, he was unsupervised. No.
Oh,
I was really. I was unsupervised.
Yeah, this is like a little. This is like
what
your
else
territory.
Happened?
Wait. We're getting too off topic
okay,
here.
Sorry,
but wait,
sorry. Let's get back to the Nazi.
Yeah. So, how did that happen? How did you get in the room with this colonel and put a gun in his mouth? Like,
well, this was during the war.
Let's hope.
And we took over this munitions dump. It was a massive, it may have been 10, 15 square acres of,
Jesus.
They had a pit of, you know, you've seen these big cisterns of gasoline, those big gasoline things that you see.
Nitroglycerin?
Yeah. Yeah, they had nitroglycerin.
Spaceships.
No.
They had the crazy Hitler spaceships.
Spells. And,
yeah, no. But I did uncover, we did uncover at the time jets.
Oh, my God.
Jet planes that never got off the ground.
Oh, like the Nazis were going to use some sort of new strategy?
Yeah, was this like new technology?
Oh, yeah.
How did we not bomb the shit out of that munitions plant?
Huh?
How come it wasn't, how come we didn't bomb it?
We didn't, no. Did
well, it? You couldn't.
You couldn't see it?
This was in Germany, and it was built over in the forest.
Oh,
well, plus,
okay.
Wait, it was captured, too, so, right? You don't want to bomb a captured...
No, but
no,
she's
no, I'm saying before they came in, why didn't they bomb it first?
Yeah,
but
yeah,
it was camouflaged.
There's a few that fell.
Hey, wait just
cracks.
A second now.
So, wait, so what, did you guys storm this munitions dump, and there's still Nazis that didn't escape yet?
No, I didn't storm shit.
You just came in after they'd already been captured?
I came in a Jeep.
Uh-huh.
With a couple, I had a couple of guys. You know, it's going back many, many years. But
remember, damn it!
Where's the one-armed man?
We came into this munitions dump. I found out that this colonel was in plain clothes and went into the city.
Oh, he was trying to sneak out.
Yeah, and. We found him, and we brought him back. And when we brought him back, that's when I stuck the gun in his mouth.
Yeah. Did you tie him up?
No.
What'd you say to him?
Yeah, recite it exactly word for word. I want to know.
No, he knows. He told me.
Yeah, so what did you say?
You said something in German, right?
Well, it wasn't German. It was half Yiddish.
Uh-huh. Oh, but I want to hear it.
Sure
but you know, it sounds German.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's because Yiddish is kind of German.
Yeah. Well, it's an offshoot of German.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yiddish is basically a bastard language of both Polish and German.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what did you say to this guy?
Yep.
This rapscallion.
What did I say?
You got
this is your Clint Eastwood
peanut
moment.
Butter and my jelly. And he said, "You got jelly in my peanut butter." Wait a minute.
I said. I gave him a lot of bullshit.
You're feeling lucky.
Did you have any intention of killing him, or were you just wanting to scare him? For a second, did you ever think you were going to kill him?
I could have killed him.
But would you have?
I would have.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, really, I could have killed him.
Yeah.
I could have killed him because of what I've seen in the concentration camp.
Mm-hmm.
This was at Buchenwald when all this happened. Right in that area. And, you know, after you see the death camps and you see all of this.
Yeah.
You
want to get revenge.
Life isn't that important to you anymore.
Yeah.
You just want to take this asshole and blow his head off.
Yeah. How did you not? How did you restrict? Like, because I think if I were in your shoes, I would have just been like... I would have had a belt with notches
like
on
the
it.
End of seven.
No, I would have been like Inglorious Bastards. I would have been going with as many as I could kill.
Shoot and ask questions later.
Yeah. How did you not shoot this guy? At least get the info and then I don't know.
When you see all the cruelty that man can do unto man, you can't comprehend these things.
Mm-hmm.
You can't comprehend how can they take kids and gas them. How can they take
a person
and gas him? Mm-hmm. But I think it's got to do with how you brought up.
Yeah.
Really. Yeah. How you brought up.
And are you brainwashed by an insane dictator?
Well, we should explain this.
That's correct. Yeah. Because, you know, if you hear the story long enough and often enough,
yeah.
you believe the show.
Oh, sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, that's all you need is like a five question sort of like test.
Well,
like,
here's the thing, though, is my grandfather was, I mean, there wasn't a lot of Jewish soldiers.
Well, I wanted to ask your grandfather, were you ever scared when you were in, what years were you in? Like, for you said, like, 40?
I went into the service in May the 2nd of 1942.
So were you, you volunteered, right? Yeah.
So, I was stupid.
No, in the army too.
No, I wasn't stupid. I was trying to run away from a girl.
Oh yeah, that's a
cool
story.
You want to hear this?
Can you tell
that story
real quick? Wait, can I ask him a question?
Okay,
and then
I want to hear that story.
That's another story.
Well, wait, can I ask him my question and then we'll get to the joke?
That's what I want to hear. Though
I just wanted to ask: were you ever on your dog tags? Did it say H for Hebrew? Were you ever afraid being in German German soil that if you got captured they would find your dog tag and see that you were Jewish? Were you ever afraid of
that?
Did
they put H on your dog tag?
They never.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Are you serious?
Yes.
What?
No, yeah.
What's up with that? Yeah. Why?
They put your religion on the dog tag.
Yes. Oh my god. Well, that's not cool.
They had P for Protestant, C for Catholic. Mm-hmm. And
in case
H for
you
Hebrew.
Find this
Are
one.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
There were no Muslims then.
They didn't have JB for.
We didn't know what we didn't know. What Muslims were.
Yeah.
Oh my
god.
Were you
ever afraid of being captured and then not only being captured but then them finding out that you were Jewish and did that ever cross your mind?
You know, you don't think like that.
No.
Well, you came in after they were all bombed out.
Well, true, but still.
Did you show?
Bombed out. I was there. What do you mean when?
You were still there when, and there was a lot of action still happening in.
Well, I came in there.
Yeah.
I came in there when they were fighting in the forest.
Did you see Tom Hanks?
Oh, stop!
And what's the guy?
You didn't have to fight in the Arden, did you? You weren't. You where did you fight? What?
No, I didn't. I was in Ordnance Intelligence.
Okay, gotcha.
Wait, Papa.
Not that I was intelligent.
He was in the bomb disposal squad.
Yeah.
He had to bomb knock on
I had the shittiest job in the world.
Oh, my God. Okay, wait, hold
but
on.
But at least it kept you out of the battles.
No.
Well on the front, not the front lines.
So to speak.
Yeah.
Did you show the Nazi your dog tag? It said H? Like, is there any
when you had the gun in his mouth, did you go, look at my dog
did
tag?
Did you want to show them that you were Jewish? Like, was
no.
It,
no? It didn't matter?
Did you see Inglourious Basterds, Papa?
Huh?
Did you see Inglourious Basterds?
Yes.
What'd you think of it?
I thought it was a good
Two
movie.
Two thumbs up.
What's your favorite World
My
War II
Papa's
movie?
My papa's a real Inglourious.
Okay, wait.
Wait,
hold
what's
on,
your,
Jackie.
What,
why I just want to say we're here. Oh, we're here with Ryan Ridley's grandfather, the legend, the myth, the World War II veteran.
He's 89 years old.
89 years old, 89 years young.
Also known as the Red Baron.
A.K.A. the Night Fighter.
Yeah.
Papa, what do you have to say about being old?
It's better than being dead.
Yeah, that's
but
a good
it also
one.
It also ain't worth
a hill of beans.
You know, it ain't worth a shit.
Yeah,
really.
and the only thing
because all the equipment don't work anymore.
Yeah, that's right. And the only thing golden about the golden years is
golden boots.
Get it?
Rumpelstiltskin.
What is it, Ryan? Just tell us.
The only thing golden about the golden years is your piss.
Oh yeah, that's exactly.
Well,
what
unless
I told
unless you've been drinking all night.
Wait, yeah. Be quiet. What's your favorite World War II movie? Like depiction.
Wait,
of World
I need
War
to get
II.
The mic on his. I need to hold on real quick.
Wait, he's perfectly clear.
Did you like? I can hear him fine.
Yeah, I poured my papa his favorite drink, absolute vodka and tall glass with a lemon twist.
Wonderful.
Yeah. How is it? How'd I mix it, Papa?
Good. You know how I like it.
That's right.
Do you have a favorite movie?
Favorite grandson.
No, of world a depiction
Vice
of World
versa,
War II.
Starring...
Did you like Saving Private Ryan or?
Let's do the Papa Poll.
Papa Poll.
Saving Private Ryan was pretty accurate.
She's saying the favorite of all.
But what's
time.
Your favorite? What's your favorite World War II movie?
What's your favorite Call of Duty game?
Do you really play? No, you're kidding, right? Okay.
Not.
I don't
did
know.
Did you? Do you know they make video games
that about that, World War II? It's the that. Most common. It's the most common basis for
it's
a game nowadays.
It's gotta be horrible to like. Because it's a game that's based on a real war where you're like running around
killing,
fighting.
Yeah, yeah. Now, they haven't made one where you play as a Nazi, thank God.
Well.
You just kill them. You kill them. Well, the Nazis are some of the most iconic villains in the history of man. Yeah. So, of
and
course, they're going to make
it. Stuck a gun in one's mouth.
Okay, so you did a
yeah,
win.
Baby!
You didn't shoot the guy. What did you say?
A little late on the applause there. Yeah, what did you say to him? In Yiddish, let's hear it, word for word.
He
come
can't
on.
Remember.
Okay,
why
tell you what.
Keep asking
no,
him
no, just
over
make it up.
Over.
Make it up. Something like, what would you? If I was a Nazi and you had a gun in my mouth, come on, just something fresh off the top of your head.
What did I say? Oh,
come on, work yourself.
He
up.
Said to me, "Sie sprechen Sie Deutsch?" I says, "Nicht so viel," which is already, you know, that's "Nicht so viel" is not German.
Yeah,
it's Yiddish.
But he knew what you meant.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because it's a derivative.
What does nicht zu viel mean?
Not too much.
Wait, what did he ask you? What's going on?
No, right now, did you speak German?
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Yeah.
And you said, not too much?
The first thing I said to him, when I got this guy, I said, Was ist los mit der Luftwaffe? That's the Air Force, the German Air Force.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And he says, nicht kein fucking Benzin.
Which is?
Gasoline.
Uh-huh.
Benzin was gasoline.
So what you were asking him how you powered the aircraft?
What happened to the Luftwaffe? And he said, nicht kein fucking Benzin.
Ran out of gas?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
You got it.
Yeah. Wait a minute. What was he saying? Like
he ran out of gas. Like, what happened
the whole,
here?
The whole German Air Force ran out of gas?
Are you paying attention?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
When the 8th Air Force came over, they took care of everything that there was no fucking place to get gas anymore.
Oh, the Air Force bombed all the gas stations,
nice.
Essentially?
Yeah.
Oh, that's
except
one way to
the
take
munitions
care of it.
Dump.
I know, that's why I was asking, why did that munitions dump survive? But it's because it was camouflage.
Yeah.
I know they bombed the hell out of it.
Okay, so you got the information from them. Then what'd you do?
Dustin.
Then what did I do? Oh, when we took over this munitions dump, they had a big table.
Oh,
this
on
is
mic.
Great. This is great.
Okay.
I'll pop
the
my mic.
Here, just was, tilt the mic back to your... There you go. There.
Table was about 8...
There she is.
Table was about 8 foot long. You know, a big conference table?
Yeah.
And I'm sitting there. We're sitting there. And look at this big fucking table. We're sitting there and we're talking. And I don't know, I'm playing around, and the next thing, I got my fingers underneath the table, and there's buttons, and I press a button, and this fucking table turns over.
What?
Wow!
It splits and it turns over.
And on the other side is a map.
And on the other side of the table is the whole layout of this munitions.
Whoa!
Wow.
That is so crazy.
God.
Yeah, really. The whole munitions dump is laid out there.
Yeah.
So you stumbled upon that.
Yeah,
so they sat there and it was like a game of Risk.
Yeah. I went in and I found nitroglycerin tanks, big tanks of nitroglycerin. You threw a coin in it and it disappeared, you know. You can drop a person in it and they'd be gone.
So, my papa was one of the few Jews, right? You're one of the few Jews in your unit. That's fair to say, right? And what happened when your fellow American soldiers found out?
Weren't they shitheads to you?
Well, why don't we find out?
At the beginning, I took a lot of shit.
Uh-huh.
They treated him like Sammy Davis Jr.
This is absurd. I mean, what?
Well, that's what my mom told the story. What happened?
You see, the black people, number one, were service people. Uh-huh. They drove the trucks.
Mm-hmm.
And when they found out I was a Jew, man.
Wait, the black guys were giving you shit?
No.
Oh.
Oh, they were cool with you.
The Protestants and the Catholics.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
How did they find out? Because of your tag?
Yeah, it's like, Jew here! H! Big H on the
Is that
the
how
tag.
They find out, Papa?
Because oh, the biggest letter.
No, no, no.
How they found out.
His last name?
How they
you ordered matzo balls for lunch. Bad idea, Papa.
No, yeah, matzo ball soup.
No. How they found out is that when I went in and I was taking off for the holidays, for the Jewish holidays, I had to apply for a pass.
Uh-huh.
And when I applied for the pass, then they knew that I was a Heeb.
Yeah. Their words.
Then I had the mark on me.
Yeah. And what happened?
He had to save a bunch of their lives. And then he said, he's all right.
We learned our lesson.
Did you get verbal abuse or physical abuse? Well, how'd they treat you?
They tolerated me. Let's put it that way.
Yeah. But what about
what was your rank? Did you outrank any of these guys, or were you equal?
What was your rank in the Army?
Well, I was busted a few times, but I wound up being a nice private.
What do you mean you're busted a few times?
Oh, you're telling that story?
He was carving potatoes.
I'm asking questions. What do you mean you're busted a few times?
Didn't you do some time in Iraq?
Yes, I went out with a Navy lieutenant.
Female.
That came off a boat.
Uh-huh.
And we went out and got drunk, and we partied, and...
I can't believe it.
Is this in Baghdad?
How dare
this was
you?
This happened to be in Basra, Iraq.
Uh-huh. My grandfather was in the Iraq War, Justin.
Okay, yeah, okay.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, go on, Bubba.
No, he wasn't. Come on.
I was in Iraq and Iran.
Fool me once.
So it was like the Casbah there.
Yeah.
I got drunk, and I was with this friend of mine... Tony Nowicki.
A Polak?
A Polak from
Sholok.
A Polak just, and a Jew go to the Casbah.
Just a nice guy. He lived in Chicago.
Did he operate in a submarine that had a screen door in the Army?
Hey, take it easy.
No, you're passing those kind of jokes?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Hello.
Okay.
Jeez, just straight out of the oldest joke book in the world.
Go on.
We're going to hit Henry the Turtle.
It was written on wooden or stone tablets.
Go on. So you're partying in Iraq with the Polak.
He was so dumb.
No, he wasn't dumb.
No, I'm kidding.
He was a nice guy.
Yeah.
He went to the can with me.
Yeah, well, how'd you go to the can?
Oh, the can.
Uh-huh. Well, how'd you go to it?
Not
Why?
Cannes Film Festival.
Well,
we're talking about
We went out with this Navy lieutenant that he came off of a merchant ship. Mm-hmm. And we got drunk.
Mm-hmm.
And this was in Basra, Iraq.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. We got drunk and we got picked up. I'll never forget the guy's name, too.
Mm-hmm.
What was his name?
Rene J. Hicks was the provost marshal, which is the, you know what that is?
No.
That is the Obergruppenführer
of the US,
of the police department.
Uh-huh. Oh, boy.
Of the MPs.
From the MPs.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Oh, so he spots you out.
Rene J. Hicks. Yeah, I'll never forget this.
Wait, and this is the Polish guy?
No. This is the guy who's going to arrest him.
He's drinking with the Polish guy.
Okay, sorry. Okay.
Okay.
The guy that's going to arrest you.
Why'd they arrest you?
Drunk and disorderly.
Yeah. No.
What
we
did
walked
you do?
We walked into this.
What did you do?
We walked into a notch house.
Which is
a whorehouse.
Whore. Now, why they call it a notch house?
Is that like a snatch house?
And what were you doing in there, Papa? Was it because you thought it?
We were just sightseeing.
Yeah, you thought it was the church.
Yeah.
No, but
you Rene, thought it was synagogue.
Rene J. Hicks, which was the which was the provost marshal, which was the chief of police, so to speak, in the Army. He was there.
You walk into the whorehouse and you saw your.
And he was already there getting services?
Oh, he was getting a blue job.
No, I'm sorry.
So he said, this is true. He said, what the hell are you guys doing here? And I don't know none, but I said, well, put up your pants and talk to me. He said, hey, you're out of bounds and get out of here. So we left there. And as we got out of there, his Jeep was right in front. We took his Jeep. I didn't. See, I wouldn't do that.
The Polish, right. the Polish guy.
You were just a passenger.
Right, of course.
Yeah, yeah. The Polish guy did it. And you were like, oh, well, right.
Nowicki.
Yeah. Nowicki.
Yeah.
Nowicki. So we took this Jeep, and we're in Basra, Iraq, and we're going up this street and that street. You have to visualize these streets. They're very narrow. It's like a maze.
Yeah.
You can't find your way out. If yeah. you don't hit the right road, you're not going to get out of there.
Yeah.
So we wind up back
at the notch
where Renee J. Hicks is standing there, the provost marshal, with his fucking .45 like this.
Pointed at you. Yeah. What's going on, buddy?
And he says, stop. Oh, you're not going to go forward. We stopped. And the next thing you know, he's going to put us in a can.
Well, now, you stole the car, though.
They were taking it for a joyride.
We took
ride.
His Jeep. Just we took his ride. Jeep,
you
too.
Kind of, yeah, yeah, exactly. Or yeah. the Jeep. You stole
Justin,
the Jeep.
Would you have done anything any different?
Not at all. I would have done the same thing.
Well, he was getting a blowjob. What? Yeah. You know, he yeah. wasn't on duty.
Yeah. So, screw him. Yeah. Taking the Jeep.
Yeah, so we're now here. Okay, now there's no jail. So there's an ice house in Basra, Iraq.
Like a meat locker?
An ice house uh-huh. with ice in it.
Okay.
We had to empty out the ice out of the ice house.
Uh-huh. So he's got a gun to you while you're doing this.
Yeah. We empty out the ice out of the ice house, and he put us in there. And the next thing you know, I'm standing before a court-martial, and oh. they say, a special court-martial... I get 6 months in the can.
Ooh.
4 months and 60, 4 months and 15 days with good time.
Whoa.
And I had to dig graves to begin with in the desert. This is in Iran.
Oh, my God. Did you strike oil while digging the graves?
And the first thing, I'm in this can, uh-huh. and I meet this big black guy.
Green Mile.
No, there's no Bubba. Kidding.
He stuck
a shiv in my neck.
What?
Oh, no shit.
Did he break skin?
This is better than I've been.
No, he just stuck it like this. No, he just stuck it like that.
Uh-huh. He was in the army too, and also a prisoner, or also.
Oh, he was in the can.
What are you doing in the ice house?
Okay.
The best of the worst, or so the worst happened? Of the best, I guess.
That was the beginning.
Uh-huh. Did you guys end up becoming friends though?
No, but
I did become
friends with the police and prison sergeant.
Uh-huh. Nice.
Who happened to be a brother lanceman.
Uh-huh. A what?
Yeah, what is that?
A lanceman?
Uh-huh.
Oh. A member of the tribe.
Oh, got it.
Jewish.
A fellow Hebe.
Jewish.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Jewish. Oh, yeah. Got it.
Anyhow, so.
And he was like, I know what you
so
are.
While I was in the can, I became his assistant. And I was able to put out the work rosters, mm-hmm. and for assigning people to duties. So while I was in there, I made about $12,000.
Nice!
Wow.
What? That's like $1 million in 1943.
Oh, because people were paying you. Wait a minute,
Papa. Someone's arriving as a guest. If you don't mind, excuse me. Hold on. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
It's me, Renee J. Hicks. I'm upset. I feel I'm being misrepresented.
Are you calling my grandfather a liar?
Well, I just want to tell my side very quickly.
Go ahead.
Here I was on a night, yeah. you know, getting some pleasures from a fine young lass.
Yeah. Okay.
My Jeep.
Was she wearing a burqa?
She was a delight. That's all I'll say. And my car was stolen. Huh? Next thing I know, I'm standing out front with a gun yeah. in my hand, pointed, yeah. just aiming towards, you know, I was going to shoot a crow.
Oh,
and then
a
Jeep pulls in front of where I'm pointing.
Uh-huh. No, they had it right in front, the provost marshal. Uh-huh. They had the sign on it.
What'd it say?
No, that's
labeled. Like, it's like the
reserve
chief yeah. of police.
Oh.
You know?
And then I went and you know, I went and hung out.
Wait a minute.
I'm Renee J. Hicks.
Mr. Hicks. Mr. Hicks.
Yes. I'll take questions now from the
Papa Jonah, do you have any questions to ask?
Do you have any
Renee
questions
Hicks?
For me? Remember me? I had the gun. I was the one.
The cocksucker put you in jail.
I'm Renee J. Hicks.
Well, yeah, but that's the simplest part. The next part was the trial.
Renee, I was there for that too.
Renee, I think you should excuse yourself.
All right. Well, I'll be on my way.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Did Renee conduct the trial?
The trial.
Uh-huh.
Here I am.
With Nowicki?
And the two of us. I see the officers getting together, and they have to get this trial over with because they have a dance to go to. And they got to make this fucking thing quick.
Uh-huh. Justice.
Yeah. Did they, call the guy up at, midnight, say we got to do a trial?
Yeah.
I mean, okay.
Wow.
So I have the trial. I'm sitting there, and yes, and what do you have to say? That's irrelevant, and that was it.
Uh-huh. You were railroaded.
Oh, yeah, sure.
And they gave you 6 months' time.
Was it a military tribunal, three guys?
Well, it was
three guys and a girl in a pizza shop.
It was what they call a special court-martial. There's three types of court-martials. There's a summary, a special, and a general.
Mm-hmm.
The general is the bad one.
Mm-hmm.
General court-martial, they can commit me to execution.
Jesus.
So they sentenced me to 6 months in jail, which amounted to 4 months and 15 days.
And when you were digging ditches, didn't you tell me that
ditches. I was digging graves.
Graves.
Yeah.
Graves. So in Iraq, you
were digging
ditches for who? Let's not
degrade the job.
Yeah, no. This is a good, pretty respectable job.
It was summer, right?
Well, wait. But hold on, Jackie. I think I remember this detail.
Hey, it wasn't a lemonade stand.
Weren't there people having relations in the graves?
What?
Oh, we used to do that.
Yeah, what happened?
We?
Well,
do tell.
Well, you know, the native girls in Iran, occasionally would come wandering by the fields and
while you're digging the graves.
We had to get service.
Jesus.
Was it, did you have to pay
They ran the service station.
Uh-huh.
Is that what it was called?
That's what I call it. Uh-huh.
Isn't that beautiful? A Jew and Iranian having sex in a grave.
In a grave.
I want to know who was getting buried in these graves.
Well, there was nobody buried in them, but in case when they're ready for them, the graves were dug.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay. If there weren't people having sex in
them. But for who? Iraqi people? Soldiers?
Well, sure.
Were buried in Iraq?
Whoever.
It's like, were they temporary graves?
Yeah,
okay,
just empty.
Gotcha, mm-hmm. Okay.
You never know, Jackie.
Whoever you want.
Sometimes they'd have temporary ones before they move them back home.
Yeah.
I want to know the story of why you joined the service. I want to know about this girl that drove you to flee and join the service.
I didn't tell him anything. You've mentioned it.
Yeah, you said it earlier, and I'll tell you what. Women. Am I right, ladies and gentlemen?
So what happened?
Hello.
Why'd you join the war? Papa, was it because you were patriotic?
No.
Was it because you saw that what the Japanese did in,
he probably,
at Pearl Harbor?
No.
No,
he was probably like, you know what? Fuck it.
What was her name?
What happened?
Sorry.
Her name was Phyllis. Okay.
Aww.
Diller?
Phyllis.
Okay.
I knew you were going to say that, Justin.
Phyllis what?
Her mother come. What's the difference? Kapitansky.
Uh-huh.
So her mother came home with her father,
mm-hmm.
and I was sitting on a... They had the stoop. You know what stoops are?
Yeah.
They had
like a porch.
They had them in the front, though, mm-hmm. in the front of the house.
Yeah.
So we're sitting in the front of the house, and I had my hand on her breast.
Uh-huh.
And they seen me with her hand on her breast.
The parents.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And the mother said, "When are you getting married?"
Uh-huh.
Just for touching her boob?
Yeah. Honestly,
Jesus,
uh-huh. That's a big deal back then.
Yeah, really. And the next
with inflation, thing, that was like, you know,
$100.
That's a true story. Uh-huh. And the next thing I joined the army.
Because
you didn't want to marry this girl. You needed to get out of town.
So if this is a movie, my grandfather would have his hand in
the rest of the story. They followed me, the mother and her, followed me to each post that I went to I was in the States.
So they were stalking you.
Yeah. In fact, they followed me. They followed me to the point of debarkation in New Jersey to when I was leaving. But the end of that story was she married a guy. What do you think his name was?
Same as yours.
Bertram.
Whoa.
That was his name.
Why were they stalking you? Just because she was madly in love with you or because you touched her boob? And she...
I didn't get nothing else.
Uh-huh. I mean, that is a...
I mean, you squeezed it a little, but...
Jeez, boy, like that's a bum rap.
I like
that's
how...
not even a two.
That's a bum rap.
I like how it's like he's got his hand on her tit.
So it must mean
like,
they have to
one
get married.
Yeah, when are you getting married? Hard cut to my grandfather in the recruitment office.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay.
I'd like to go
when
over to...
When can I go
Europe,
fight
please?
Nazis? How quick can you get me killing Nazis? Really quickly, how many Nazis did you kill, if any at all? I'm just curious. Well, come on. No. I want to know.
I didn't kill him.
Not
he
one.
He tortured him, though.
Well, that's besides the point.
So how did you let the colonel go? What was the end of that?
I turned him in over to intelligence. Mm-hmm.
Did you ever... He became like a prisoner of war.
Yeah.
Did you ever talk to them, to the German soldiers? Like once they were captured and did you ever talk to them or did you guys ever... did you just stay separate?
No, I talked to them.
What were they? Were they all just like young,
were they
dumb
so
kids?
So cute.
No, but they were just all young kids kind of just
they were
like you guys, right?
They were just misunderstood is what Jackie wants
to
know, right?
No, I'm just saying like when it gets to that point when they become prisoners and, you know, it's just like the war's over.
They just want to find a young American girl and settle down.
They're no different than an American soldier.
Yeah, that's
that is
wondering.
A controversial statement for a World War II soldier.
Well, except for their brainwashed.
They're just, well, right, but...
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah?
Hello, my name is Ludwig Hirscher. Oh, uh-huh. I'm a German... I'm the farting German. I am the farting German soldier.
Okay. Well, what are you here for?
I just want to represent. I feel I'm being misrepresented. My people are being misrepresented.
Papa, do you see some humanity in this one right here?
I'm
get
just,
a Luger out.
I'm a juicer like everyone else.
Okay, all right, Ludwig. Thank you.
All right.
Okay, Ludwig. Goodbye.
Bye.
Wait. Did you really see humanity in the German soldiers and the Nazis?
Not the Nazis, but the soldiers
he
were
saw
the same. They didn't
the
want to
light
be in that
of
war. They didn't want to fight.
He saw the light of existence in every living thing. Like a heightened spiritual... being wood.
That's bullshit.
Oh, okay. I'm speaking out of turn. I apologize.
That's bullshit.
What did you call the Germans?
As far as I was concerned, they didn't have humanity.
Okay.
For what I seen,
yeah.
You know, after going into Buchenwald and seeing the death camps, no. I didn't see that.
What did you see? I mean, you don't have to tell us what you saw in the death camps.
We should
tell
our our listeners that don't know that are 15 years old is like Buchenwald was one of the largest concentration camps on German soil.
Right.
And I think they said like final death count or something was like 56,000 killed there. It was a work camp, but it was what was that angel? There was... I wrote this down.
Oh, boy, Jackie.
No.
You're talking about...
The hangman of Buchenwald. That's the guy. No,
the woman?
Walter Sommer was like... He was a sadist. And so there's like tons of experimentation happening at this camp. And just horrific things.
He did it on kids.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Horrible.
On twins.
Yeah.
So he was like Mangala, no?
Same thing. Same thing. Yeah.
Doing
just
brain
disgusting.
Tests and fucked up shit.
Yeah.
Oh, the human race, what we're capable of as a collective
but
unit.
When you went in, was the camp already, it was liberated? Were they getting all of the people out? And like, did you get to
experience?
They
were liberated when I got there.
So you were there. You were liberating them.
Right.
Oh, my gosh.
Right, right.
Were they going... I mean, I know obviously everyone was so, like, in a weakened state, but were they so... I can't imagine what that must have felt like.
Well,
I would have
you
been...
You gotta visualize what they looked like.
Yeah. Of course, of course.
Okay. Mostly you've seen just about skin with... with skeletons.
Yeah.
Skin with like skeletons.
Walking skeletons,
right,
pretty
right,
much.
Right.
But, oh.
Well, but
they must have been so, I can't even imagine how happy and elated they must have been, even though in their weakened state.
Oh, yeah.
It must have been so, I don't know, I can't imagine.
Oh, yeah. Especially being a Jew and you run into Jews.
Yeah.
That have been there, and you do have a bond,
mm-hmm.
You know. You just if you got any humanity in your soul at all, you have to have a bond.
Yeah.
You know, you can't. You got to get tears in your eyes.
Yeah. Do you remember what any of them said to you, or do you remember, like?
Yes, I had him kiss my hand. You know, that's heartbreaking.
Yeah.
You know, it is absolutely heartbreaking.
Did you lose it? Did you start crying? Or
well, sure
how could you
yeah.
not?
How could
oh
you
my
not?
God! That, I can't even imagine.
What happened? Where did they go at directly after the concentration camp?
Well, from there,
Chuck E. Cheese.
No. We took them out of the concentration
Sorry.
Camps,
Smorgasbord.
And we set them into displaced persons camps.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And from the displaced persons camps, then they dispersed them to Palestine or wherever.
Yeah.
Like, did the Red Cross probably
yeah.
say?
What's that?
Israel, Palestine.
Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. Sheesh. What would I have done without that?
Man.
Woo.
Well, Justin,
that's heavy shit. No, seriously.
I mean, you've been through a lot. I mean, you know, you've had girlfriends cheat on you. I mean, you know,
oh,
but,
no.
but nothing... But I mean, you know,
okay.
These people can't possibly understand that, though.
No, they would never know the pain I've dealt with.
I just can't imagine, though, besides seeing the horror of the camp, but then also going in to liberate the survivors out of it. It must have been just like crazy high and low of emotions, and I don't know. It's
of course
something.
It is.
Well, in the world of, you know, charity, that takes the cake. I mean, I gave a homeless guy $20 last week, but... You know, the amount of,
oh,
you know,
Justin,
the amount of like joy I felt is a fraction.
I know what I was going to ask you.
What I would feel to liberate a concentration.
Do you still have any of your,
and I'm being serious,
in war, you know, like how you were saying you had Lugers, and do you still have your Lugers? Did you ever get like a swastika?
Yeah, did you keep anything?
I got rid of it all, but I did have it at one time.
You did collect things.
At one
yeah,
time.
Yeah.
He found a suitcase of Deutschmarks.
Wow.
Whoa.
Oh, this, yeah. I did find a suitcase of, when we took over Germany, I found a suitcase of Deutschmarks. The Deutschmarks were outlawed, and they put in occupation currency.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, like a transitional currency?
Yeah. Hmm. They put in a transitional currency. Mm-hmm. And I was really a putz. Because, you know, as soon as I did that, about 30 days later, they put the Deutschmarks back
in. Oh, no, you didn't. And you didn't have, did you turn them over? Did you turn the Deutschmarks in?
No, I think we used them for fire.
Oh, no.
Yeah, to be honest,
no. Wait, how much was it? How much was it?
Oh, it was a suitcase. I don't know.
Just a ton. I mean, you could have bought a bunch of whatever you
and
wanted.
And this is my Jewish grandfather.
Could have bought a PlayStation 3.
He deal with the money right?
Oh,
you know what
Jesus.
I'm
ah, so the stereotype is put to rest once and for all.
You know, I never thought myself as a Jewish guy. I thought myself as an American.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's the way I think today.
Were you back once the war was officially over, like once we signed with the Japanese and the war was over, were you already back in the States to celebrate the end of the war, or were you still in Germany?
Or over there somewhere.
My outfit came home before.
Oh.
Oh, so you would have gone home already if you weren't in.
Oh, my God.
If I didn't have to go to the can.
Oh. Holy crap.
So I had to spend my Easter in the can.
That Polish bad
and
influence.
And your Passover. So you were in Europe for like 6 months after the war ended, right?
Oh, my God.
He was just telling me this at the bar.
No.
Yeah. Oh. You were in Belgium, right? You want to tell that story?
Ooh, did you meet a lady there?
Did I meet a lady?
Should it be plural? Ladies?
No, I made a lady there.
Uh-huh. What was her name?
I can't exactly remember. But I do know that we went together. She used to go with a German officer.
Where did you meet her?
I met her in a cafe drinking. You know what an appetitive is?
No.
Makes you go poop.
You don't know what an appetitive is?
No, I don't think so.
That's like a wine.
Okay.
A glass of wine.
Okay.
Got it.
Okay. And I met her there, and we became friends, and I went with her for about 6 months.
Oh, wow.
And she told me that she once went with a German officer.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's not that she went with him. You asked her, how did she survive during the war?
Oh, yeah.
That's the story. Oh, mm-hmm. Boy.
She said, I survived with the war because I went with this German officer mm-hmm. who was able to give me food.
Wait, was she Jewish? She was Jewish.
No.
She was Belgium. They were occupied.
Yeah.
Oh.
Basically, the Nazis come and they invade Belgium and they're occupying force. And, you know, you kind of got to do what you got to do to survive.
Yep.
Yeah. Wow. Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
That means.
I may have a picture of her somewhere.
Oh, I'd like to see
house.
That.
Mm-hmm.
And so we went around together. And I was going from where was I? I was traveling from Belgium to, I was changing money. I was able to get my money in Antwerp or wherever it was. I don't remember the exact town. And at a higher rate.
So you traveled there to get more money for your
right.
Marks.
So yeah,
more money, more problems.
Yeah.
Basically, it was on the black market.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I would travel by train and go get double my money and then come back.
Oh, nice. And conversion rate.
And then reconvert it again and then go back.
Oh, my God. This is like me playing a role-playing game.
Yeah. That's
building
what it
my
was.
Character over yeah. Doing yeah. the same
yeah.
thing.
Take
over
the same money yeah. and
just farming gold.
Yeah, and keep going
for a whole
back
weekend.
And forth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I lived like a prince.
See, Jackie, do you see how different I am from my grandfather?
Well, I want to
know. We're
going
to get into you in a minute.
I want to fast mm-hmm. forward to how did you break her heart?
The Belgium girl?
Yeah.
You broke up with
her, right?
Maybe she broke his heart.
No way.
How she presumptuous
This is the
you.
Red Baron we're talking about.
All right.
He's the heartbreaker.
Yeah, no. She was a nice woman.
Uh-huh.
What happened?
I said, get out of here.
No, I didn't say that.
Oh, okay.
She followed me to Antwerp, Belgium. To where I got on the boat, and I went back.
Was she crying?
Was she?
Did you see her like crying at like the dock as you were drifting
yeah.
away?
Why didn't you take her with you?
Could he?
Because
could.
Then I would have never been born.
Oh. Yeah. Hello.
Did you think about bringing her or no?
No, you couldn't do it. At that time, you couldn't do it.
You couldn't just bring a girl.
It was a military ship.
Huh? No, you couldn't do it then.
Why not?
Because you just couldn't do it.
Could you have
then.
Sent for her, as they say?
No.
You could have.
But by then, you were already back in the States
but
and
good
had a
luck.
Million girlfriends.
On to the next B word.
Hey,
yeah.
This is before the internet, Ryan.
Oh, that's sad.
Oh, we have a new guest. Hello. Hello. Who's there? Hopefully, this is a good character.
Hey, how's it going, everybody?
Yeah.
I'm a suitcase full of douche marks. Hey, I just wanted to hang out with you guys for a little bit.
All right.
I've been outlawed.
Oh, you have been?
Well, in a little bit, I'm going to be legal tender again. But right now, I'm a suitcase full of douche marks.
Okay.
Get out of here.
Hey, well.
No. Deutsch marks.
Yeah.
Deutsch.
Hey, don't get mad at me. I've had too many imperatives. I'm a mess. I'm just right, a mess.
Why don't, can we just put you over here next to the Transformers?
Well, listen, I'm a giant suitcase full of Deutschmarks. So I'll just sit over here.
Okay,
and,
good.
All right.
Why don't you sit next
to
those
okay?
Legos?
Can I sit,
absolutely.
Can I sit by you, Ryan?
Sit next to, nuzzle in between some other worthless things, those Legos over there.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Hey,
whoa,
Papa,
jeez, I could get along with those things.
Papa, speaking of which, what do you think of this? What do you think of all this stuff going
this
on in
crap
here? What do you
in
think
this
of all
room,
this stuff?
All the toys.
How do you like all of Justin's Transformers? Huh?
Transformers.
You used to have those
Thank
things.
Thank you.
Oh,
yes, that's right.
Hey,
yeah.
But this... you didn't save them, asshole.
Yeah, genius.
I'm not like Justin. I got my I inherited this from you. I didn't know the value of the Transformers.
That's
you didn't
right.
know the value of the
You had
marks.
A lot of shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Papa, you're 89.
Yeah.
But you don't feel like you are, do you?
No.
You know what? That's good, though. That's a representation of him living in the now.
Yeah.
No, shit, no.
How old do you feel? How old do you feel? 50?
No, he feels as young as his soul.
30? 40?
Which is eternal.
Listen, I was out last night drinking with my daughter and Dan. Hey, I do what I've done for the last 50 years. I haven't changed a bit of the way I live.
God bless you.
I know.
I was balls deep in Ally McGraw.
Except when I raised my grandsons.
What'd you do then?
Uh-oh.
Oh, I fed them ribs.
Uh-huh. Yeah. What else? What other wisdom did you impart on me?
Pork juice.
What did I impart on
you? I don't know.
Oh, he's quite a... Here, let me read some of the questions we've got.
Yeah.
You can maybe answer.
Yeah.
What kind of baby was Ryan? Was he fussy? I bet he was fussy. So answer
no,
that one.
I no? Never, no, he was great.
Aww.
He wasn't fussy?
That's right.
Never had any problem with
Thank
him
you.
Or his brother.
Well, let me ask you a question.
My diapers were always very nice and clean.
Let me ask you a question. Are there any embarrassing Ryan stories that you might remember?
No.
Come on. There's got to be at least one.
Not really.
I mean, he told the story about him fondling a neighbor. You don't remember that?
No. Nope.
What was your perspective on that?
No, he doesn't know that story.
Right.
Don't recall it.
Yep. You know why? Because I'm an angel. I'm a prince, aren't I, Papa?
Did Ryan ever show you his film Wastelander?
Did you show me that film?
No, that's. I don't think I did.
No?
It seems
Maybe
that,
I tried to.
Yeah.
Have you seen any of my videos?
I don't think you even want to even bring them near me.
Yeah, because I don't think you get them. They're
how
not your sensibility. They're
how
too
do you
weird.
Know?
I don't
how
know.
Do you know.
Maybe one night we'll have a film festival.
Oh, I've got. Hold on. Here's a really good question for him, and I think this could be interesting to hear his response. How do you think myself and Ryan and our generation would handle living through a Great Depression or another sort of Great Depression or horrible world war? How do you think these two wallflowers over here
not survive?
The same way that I did.
Uh-huh. You think so? You guys were tougher, made tougher back
no.
then.
You're the greatest generation.
That's bullshit.
Really? I don't know.
Papa, say Tom Brokaw's full of shit.
No, the greatest generation?
Uh-huh.
Well, I think they're putting too many gold stars on it.
Yeah.
Which is very ordinary people.
Yeah.
Not the greatest generation.
Oh,
I don't agree.
I think that he's being modest and humble, but
I don't agree.
No,
I think this generation has no balls.
They would not survive. They would not.
You
Listen,
don't?
Except I'd, these two.
Hey, I'd do whatever it takes.
Nah.
So you're saying that the modern day is romanticizing your generation, and that me and Justin would be handled just as well as you did.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank
Next
you.
Question.
Oh,
I have a really
Jackie,
important wait. Question.
Who do you think knows better, my papa
I,
or
I
you?
I think he's
yeah.
being humble and modest.
Jackie,
it was much harder to grow up then.
You would run
to
Canada because of the draft.
Yeah.
Jackie, he's got more life experience
yeah,
than you.
Yeah.
His answers
You've
are correct.
You've just read it in books. He lived it, sister.
He's got you trumped, Jackie.
Wait. Papa wants to say something.
Oh, okay.
It's too loud.
No,
see,
it's not.
You got to understand something. You don't make it... It's not a joke. What we're doing and going through life, okay, I have learned many things in my life. And one thing that I've learned is that to live a life, enjoy it, and digest it and be honest. Mm-hmm. That's it.
What about selfish?
Talking to you, Justin.
What was your favorite song about Hitler?
What?
The question from the listeners.
Here's an example of my papa.
Spike Jonze song. Can
you play the songs I told you to play?
Oh, what's the song?
Play the second one I told you, the new one. Hold on.
Here we go. Really?
Not a Mel Brooks one.
Not loud.
Here we go. Hold on.
You're just gonna stand there and watch me burn.
What do you think about this?
It's all right because I like the way it hurts.
That's your boy Eminem.
Just gonna stand
Well, give it a second.
Hold on.
That's all right.
That's not Eminem.
Oh, yeah. It's coming up. That's Rihanna. She was beat by Chris Brown violently.
I can't tell you what it really is. I can only tell you what it feels like. And right now it's a steel knife in my windpipe. I can't breathe, but still fight while I can fight.
He's not bad.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. He's not bad.
Yeah, hey, Papa likes the song, right?
He's no joke.
Yeah.
He's got passion and anger.
Yeah.
He's very angry.
This is your jam, isn't it?
He likes Eminem. You like Eminem.
Yeah, but he's not Sinatra.
Yeah, all right, yeah.
Well, I don't know. You know,
why do you know Eminem? From your granddaughter?
He likes
no, he's well, from on. He's from Detroit, oh, man.
Man, a
don't
Sinatra
you
here.
Know where he's from?
Let's make a comparison, educated comparison. This is a similar song by Sinatra.
Well, this is the man.
Well, what's better? This you tell me.
This is the chairman of the board.
Someday.
Aww.
When I'm growing old. And when the world is cold.
Now, was this playing through car stereo and...
Just thinking of you.
And the way you look tonight.
Hold on.
Aww.
Wait, hold on, wait a
How
second. What just happened?
I can't breathe, but I'm still
huh? What do you want to hear? Which one?
Which
what
one,
is that?
Papa?
What is that? Wait, no, say it again.
He was a great dancer. My aunt said, until you've been, you haven't been dipped until you've been dipped by Bert.
Oh.
Because
he was the big
well,
I,
dancer.
No, I was a ballroom dancer.
Mm-hmm.
No swing dancing.
Listen, I got
swing dancing.
Would you dance
dancing.
To this song, Justin?
Bert, I got to tell you, I'm with you. I think the Sinatra's a better song out of these two songs. I'm with you, 100%.
Great song.
This makes me relax. Yeah. The Eminem song makes me want to fight somebody. I'm what the fuck's going on, man?
Great song.
Uh-huh. Yeah, this is like this
but
makes me feel.
A close second is.
Some.
I'm not prepared for this. What do you mean?
The other one.
Oh. Well, I can't jump.
Eminem
I can't.
Song.
Listen.
When the world is cold.
Hey.
I will feel a glow.
Hello.
I love you. And the way you look tonight.
Hello? Papa, you want to answer the door? Character showing up. Papa, it's all yours. Say hello.
Hawaii.
Hey, yo, what's going on, yo?
Uh-oh, who's this?
Yo, it's me, Psychic Abilities Fool.
Oh, all right.
Oh, hell, yo.
Yeah.
Yeah, yo, I just want to say, yo, mad respect.
Shit.
mad respect, you know, to Bert.
Yeah.
Yo, for all the crazy shit he dealt with, yo.
Like what? You want to rap about it?
Damn. You know what I'm saying?
You want to rap about it, Psychic?
Yeah, I got a little something
right,
here.
Let's hear it, a tribute.
I'm going to go ahead and rap over this Frank Sinatra song here.
Yeah, let's hear it.
All right. I'm going to give you all a little mix.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here we go.
Mm-hmm.
All right, yo. Yo. Talking about... some crazy stuff, yo.
Yeah.
I'm gonna try to up tempo it.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. All right, here it is. Yo.
Yeah.
Yo, hey, he was in the war, motherfucker. Yo, this motherfucker was in World War II. Hey, check me out. I got psychic abilities, fool. You want lottery numbers? Yo, I got them. Hey. What team is going to win the Super Bowl? Yo, I'll tell you about it. All right.
Papa, what do you think of this guy?
Yeah, did I... Yo, do you think I made
Maybe I made the Sinatra song better.
Psychic, why don't you rap about things that you learned from my grandfather's stories?
All right, yo. Yeah. Hey, he stole a chest full of douche-oints. Yo, he, Rene J. Hicks got him with the gun almost. Yo, hey, yo, he, straight up, Gene Gillis said, watch my kids, yo. He met his wife that way, fool. Hey, watch out. Uh-oh. Hello. Hey, yo, I'm psychic abilities, yo. Hey, you want to know the future? Hey, you know, there's only one life source, yo. We're all connected. All right.
All right.
Yo, peace.
It's beautiful.
All right, guys, I got to go. I got a doctor's appointment.
Yay.
How'd you like that guy?
Very good.
All right. Wow. Wow. That was a wonderful interview, I must say, with Bert Ridley. No? Yeah,
Gladstone. Yeah.
Gladstone.
Gladstone.
Ah, it's all the same. Jeez. Bunch of Jews.
No, it's not.
I'm kidding.
The Ridley side is not Jewish.
I'm just kidding. Come on. Irish. Take it easy.
You know, my uncle's the one who listens, whose daughter listens to the
show. I know.
Yeah.
And I already apologized.
How come you didn't bring her?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I should say something to my grandson.
Yeah, say hello to your granddaughter.
Yeah, say something
gentle. She's
not gentle.
Allowed to listen anymore.
No.
It's
why
probably
isn't
my
she
fault.
Here?
We're confiscating your iPad, your iPod, your iThing, your eyeballs.
Listen, she's a young
Why isn't she here?
Wait, hold on.
Okay.
Okay. This is to my granddaughter, Jordan Faith Gladstone. Hey, baby, I love you. Remember.
That's beautiful.
Take care, honey.
I want to know why she didn't come tonight.
Are you kidding? The show is rated R, Jackie.
I wanted to meet her.
He would freeze up a little. Maybe.
Yeah.
I wanted to meet
all right.
himself.
Thank you so much, Bert, for coming and talking to us.
Anytime.
It was a pleasure.
Yay. Oh, my God. I didn't want to stop.
I think we should do the show again.
Yeah.
Oh. Can we?
I like to eat turds.
All right, everybody, it's time for our favorite new segment in the show, Jackie's What's Going On in the World.
Yay!
Is that what it's called?
Yep.
What's going on in the world?
I am going to ask you right now, do not try to feign ignorance.
I honestly don't know this.
You do, too.
No, I don't. I really don't. I have feigned ignorance in the past on certain things.
Yeah, I don't think you should fake it.
I'm not. I'm going to be honest with you. I really promise
okay, so Jackie,
I don't
tell,
know what,
tell
what's
Justin
going on.
What's going on.
Yeah, what is this?
A little something happening in Libya.
A little something happening in Libya.
Get a little closer to the mic, Jackie.
Well, I need
is
my
that like
notes
labia?
Here.
Is that like a labia?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Hey.
Do you
come
know
on,
who Gaddafi is? You know that name.
Is that
name.
Like a labia? Oh, yeah.
1 point for Justin.
I win.
Why? Why is he up points?
I win. I turned your news story into a mockery. All right, go ahead. What is it? In Libya, what happened?
Do you know the dictator that runs? Do you know what his
know
name
him? Is? He's my best friend.
I believe that in the 80s they called him Gaddafi.
Yeah, you got it.
Oh.
He's been around for
it's
a long time.
Yeah, it's like a popular name. It's like Hussein Saddam Hussein.
I know him because I remember reading Mad Magazine when I was a kid, and he was made fun of.
It was a big deal in the 80s.
Yeah.
That's like
did they do Gaddafi Duck?
Yeah, I'm sure they did.
Did they?
Yeah.
Well, that's an obvious one.
He's
anyway,
school.
So what did he do?
He's an old school bad guy.
So what
anyways,
did he do?
It's the same thing that was happening in Tunisia and Egypt. People are gathering together to protest.
To get rid of this guy.
Well, that and...
one world government.
They're calling for, let's see, greater democracy, more jobs, an end to police brutality.
America
and,
East.
You know how Gaddafi responded to it by snipering protesters and killing them point
well,
blank.
You know, that's
not
one,
him,
that's
his,
one way
his
to
forces.
Do it.
Just him on his palace.
That's one way to go about
execute,
it.
Just executing people.
And that's exactly what they're trying to stop.
And but the latest thing.
Oh,
irony. I didn't read today's news about it, but there was like people going to the funerals of their family members who were already executed at these protests.
Uh-oh.
And the snipers set up there to kill the mourners.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, you know, the gloves are off.
Yeah.
Well, these dictators have to be running scared.
Well, it's
the pressure's
but they're saying too the reason why there's more, you know, killing and you know, what's the word I'm looking for?
Maiming.
Yeah. Well, torturing. They're getting away with more of it because of the money there, because of the oil money uh-huh. that's in.
Oh,
you're
saying the U.S. is sort of turning a blind eye?
Well, that's funny. No, it's good that the U.S., I think, is staying out of it. I mean, that's kind of what.
Can I just say something? Mm-hmm. Wouldn't the better approach be if you got protesters that are like, get out of here, we're sick of it. Why not kill them with kindness? Why send snipers out? And that's only going to make them more
recommend?
Angry.
Because
how
you've
you
got
recommend?
Them
well,
controlling
like,
them.
Send flowers to everyone and be like...
They're not going to do
like,
that.
Oh, he's not so bad.
Yeah, like give them all a fucking money. Like, give them all 20 bucks. You know, like, buy them all Nintendo 3DSs. Yeah. Everyone will be, like, too busy to play Mario in 3D.
Oh,
they won't care.
That's actually kind of smart.
I mean, you know, look, it's going to be a little bit more expensive, but, I mean, at the end of the day, you know, come on.
Yeah.
Because this is not working. This is only going to make them hate you more. And then it's going to keep.
It's
going to just
that way.
End.
What's going on in the world?
The Republican who's trying to overthrow the child labor laws.
Wait, I thought that was in Wisconsin.
Oh boy.
No.
Okay.
No, the
Sorry.
Representative. The representative is from Missouri.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I think.
And she wants to do what now? Tell it to me like I don't know anything about it, because I don't.
She wants to repeal the
ban on
child
what a
labor.
Is.
What?
Justin, explain what a senator is.
No, stop.
Oh, God, that's boring.
We don't know how far we
I know about,
say,
about
you
senators
know,
from
you know,
Star
okay,
Wars.
Okay, I'll try to make you. You know, in oldsy times, there were children that were worked to death here in America.
Yeah.
You know, because their
the good old
were,
days,
fingers
I call
were
it.
Small. They could go and work the loom and do all this stuff. So they set up all these laws to protect them.
Kids actually have to work.
Yeah, good. The golden age.
Yeah.
The good old days.
Anyways.
Listen, my kids are going to have to fucking work and put their little tiny hands in places that, you know, I can't get to that might cut their fingers off if they're
not
careful.
A Missouri state senator has proposed legislation to eliminate child labor laws altogether in Missouri.
Why?
And her reasoning is like because, you know, it's... Because
it makes me horny. If you really dig deep.
Uh-huh.
It's because it makes me horny.
Her reasons are retarded. It's just like that, God... Work like it's not
There's
up.
No
to, it's
federal.
Not up. It's not up to the government to decide if a child should work or not.
It's and, up to that child and their parents.
Yeah, exactly. And so if the parents want them to work,
she,
they
obviously
can,
she's a Republican. I mean, that goes without saying.
Well, I mean, you know, to a certain extent, I kind of see what she's saying. I mean, why can't a kid fucking work? You know what I mean? Like the second
you know, why isn't it up to the states to decide if black people can be held as slaves also?
Hold on. That's
I mean,
fucking different. That is so different. I mean, Jesus Christ.
She,
because that's horrible.
Well,
that's like an adult like being
her
fucking...
main thing is that children don't learn
about
a good work
a
ethic. Her main argument is like they won't. These
no, you're
children
right.
don't like, learn a good work ethic.
No, these kids
you know,
are growing
and
up
spoiled,
and,
yeah.
and they're fucking sitting around and living with their parents until they're 50 and then fucking
but
robbing banks.
Here's what I have to say is I think if a kid... is under this is why this is where I read this and I was like okay obviously this woman is a lunatic
right,
and she's
yeah,
a fucking
yeah,
idiot
yeah, yeah.
Missouri
Let's hear
dumb
it.
Country bumpkin but I worked illegally
whoa dun dun dun
yeah I worked illegally I because I wanted money and I still kept my grades up
what
my
did
parents
you do?
Were like I worked at like
Hooked?
A hamburger shack
what hamburger shack
Cousins Burgers.
Uh-huh. How old were you?
I think I started, I was like 13.
Didn't they like...
Did you lie and say
uh-huh.
you were...
Yeah. And I had the school had sign see... off my paperwork.
At 13.
And...
Wow. See, this is what
but,
I'm talking
but
about.
It
underage
was not...
women in porn. We need... there has to be some scientific way to test how old you are by drawing your blood
wait
and like
minute,
running
to
your...
Oh, because you watch underage porn.
No, I don't. I'm saying that like if you were able to get away with working at 13 at a Burger Hut and lying and saying you were 18 and they let you do
well,
it...
Well, not 18. You have to be 15.
Well, whatever.
You have to be 15 and
little
get
girls are
permission.
Obviously probably getting away with... like.
Well, it's not they're getting away. They're probably
they're lying.
Been kidnapped and they're part
no.
of a...
There
just
are girls who are lying
trade.
And saying, I'm
sex
19.
Trade.
And
no,
just
that's different
and...
than working at a hamburger shack.
Justin,
there
vivid,
needs to be legislation.
Vivid video is a little more scrutinous.
Excuse me, I'm not talking about vivid video.
Cousin's hamburger
yeah.
shack.
What's going on in the world?
Did you hear about those cranes that, again, some hillbillies, they're endangered species?
Uh-huh.
Like this group of... preservationists or whatever, like people that protect animals. What is that called? I can't remember.
Animal
like,
protectors.
You know, the people that help breed condors because they're extinct.
Yeah.
I can't remember
the
names.
Animal
Anyways,
protectors.
There's
tree hugging pussies.
No, there's this people that were raising this specific type of crane and they, you know, monitor them and track them.
Okay.
And somehow, whenever these cranes finally make it south, they mate with, you know, and they
yep.
have a baby, whatever, someone fucking kills these birds, shoots them, and leaves them for dead.
What?
Yes.
Why?
They're trying to. They don't know why, but it's in Georgia. In Georgia, they just found three dead
poachers,
and it's within the last like something like 14 months or something. I don't have my paper.
I would wager that person who's killing
them
is
sick.
Probably got a low IQ or is a child, like a teenager. One of those two things.
It sounds like they're just going, oh, yeah. These are the ones that people want to save.
Killed by gunshot in South Georgia.
So these guys are like probably getting off on killing these white birds. It's just, you know, it's like.
So you think that they don't even know what species it is. They don't know if it's endangered.
No.
They're just like, we're going to fucking kill it on our
property. Hey, look, there's another one of them white pretty ones. Grab the gun. All right.
That is sick.
Wait a minute. You don't think that those things are endangered, do you?
I hope not.
It's 2011. It's so creepy.
Boy,
that
would make
still
me feel really bad.
Me too.
Well, let's not think about it.
All right.
Oh, boy, you got him. Right in the head. Yeah. All right, let's go. Leave him there, though.
I do have a little guilt, just in case maybe that
Here.
Someone is breeding them.
Oh.
To save them, I don't know.
Don't you think it's weird that it's 2011 and there's still people that live like it's, you know, the Deliverance, the movie? That's what's creepy to me.
Well,
when you watch shows like Hoarders and stuff and you see these inbred, nasty.
Yeah, but have you seen,
like,
what is that?
Even all this
Mike
technology.
Idiocracy?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty much
what's happening.
I know, but
it's just crazy. You think that is not happening anymore.
No, it is.
But
it
totally is.
No, it is.
Sad.
It is. And it'll only get worse.
I think that it just makes me feel better because I'll want to become one of the global elite who educates myself and learns to manipulate.
Educates myself?
Yeah, I want to.
Who educates myself and kills crimes.
And learns how to. No.
I'm going to shoot a crime.
No. I'm going to join a secret society.
Yeah, I want to join like the. How do I join
I want to get into the Bilderbergers.
Yeah, how do I join one of these secret societies that are controlling
Skull
the world?
And bones.
Get in the government.
Uh-huh.
Get in the government.
No, they're being the government's who's
being
controlled.
Be a Mason. Be a Freemason.
You gotta be a Freemason.
Wait, how long do you think it takes to like before the
oh,
Freemasons
man.
Finally
no.
go like?
It's
all
about
fine.
That's family. It has to
family.
Be something that's passed
yeah,
on.
Yeah, dude.
Generation.
Plus, you're Jewish. You don't stand
you're
a shot.
Out.
You don't stand a shot.
Are you serious? They don't.
I'm
like,
pretty sure. Yeah, I think it's.
They
oh yeah,
can't,
no, no,
they can't say
no, no, because they're fixing to kill all the Jews. I mean, they're fixing
what?
To like another Holocaust.
What are
oh,
you
yeah,
talking
yeah.
about?
Well, I mean, of course, obviously.
Freemasons?
Where are you getting your information?
Listen, these people are bad,
uh-huh.
and they want to kill the Jews, uh-huh. just like all through history.
Uh-huh.
I mean, come on.
No, I heard that the Freemasons actually had something to do with wanting to build the temple again,
and then kill the Jews that go to it. They want to build the temple just so they can pick out, okay, he's going in. Okay, he's Jewish. Mark him and his family and everyone in that line of, you know what I mean? That's how they fucking do it. Because they're Bilderbergers. I don't even know what that means.
Jewish.
Yeah, no, that's where Jackie worked when she was 13.
The Bilderberger Foundation.
Bilderberger.
You know, when I first heard Bilderberger, that's what I thought of as Build-A-Bear. Build-A-Bear. It sounds like a cute name.
You build your own burger.
The Bilderberger is Bilderberger.
You want lettuce? Just mark it on the paper.
That'd be funny if the Bilderberger Association, like this secret society,
they just built. They just like it's like a big barbecue.
No, they still have the main building where they scheme and plot. They're like, okay, we're gonna give AIDS to Africans.
But then they have
outside of the Bilderberger.
Yeah. It's like a franchise.
And then like step one, pick your bun.
They're really delicious.
You want whole grain?
I know it's helping support the eventual demise of America and the world. But boy, these burgers are tasty.
I mean, you can pick whatever kind. You can pick sesame seed, pumpernickel.
Hormone-free, FDA, beautiful cow meat.
100% organic.
Do they let people with AIDS or Jews into the burger joint?
Of course, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Wait, what?
I mean, what better way than to have their money pay for their own?
Of course,
okay.
You know? Yeah.
It's a little expensive, but tasty. I want bacon.
Yeah.
Just mark it on the sheet.
Hard-boiled egg for me, please.
It's $2 extra.
No problem. It's delicious.
All right.
Ooh, look at the kinds of cheeses we have.
800.
And then cut to like inside, and they're just like, okay, so we're going to start a new war in China. We're going to manipulate the stock market.
At what point do we kill all the Jews?
What kind of peppers do you want? Oh, jalapeno, please.
Hello. All right, it's time for listener email, the Jewish grandpa version.
How'd you guys like that interview, huh?
Loved them.
He came out of his shell. I was a little nervous.
You know, it's funny.
Oh, no, he was great.
Did that give you any perspective?
You know, it gave me a lot of perspective.
Yeah?
It made me realize that I'm going to die.
Uh-huh.
And that...
But you may not die for, like, at least 60 years.
It made me realize that my energy, my life energy,
mm-hmm.
will be folded into the one complete life energy that we all drink from.
Sorry.
Okay.
This is... Eckhart Tolle. I've been here the whole time.
No, come on!
He is right. The one. The now. The only. The light.
Hey, Eckhart, are you a Nazi? I kill Jews in my free time. Okay, all right.
Let's go.
Let's do it. First email.
Listener.
On the email train. The big old dirty dumb email.
First ever fan apology is the subject of this next email.
All right. Mm.
Well, you got something to say?
Yeah, I just want to make sure that we don't skip the video game email.
I don't know what that means.
Well, Jackie will help me
not
forget.
Okay.
This is from Greg. He says, "Dear GVP, this is Greg Stefanakis again, writing back with the first ever fan apology. I've been doing a bit of drinking before the construction of my last email and wasn't very careful with my words or choice of topics. I never meant to call Ryan egotistical and self-involved or call Jackie a fuck machine."
What? I don't even remember
this. Neither do I.
You guys know how much I love the show, so I'm asking for forgiveness and hope you will give me a second chance.
Well,
forgiveness.
Yeah, you're done. You're good. You're okay.
I did the cross over his face.
You're all right.
Help smooth over this apology. I will start with a dumb joke for Jackie to lighten the mood. Then I'll offer
you're a
compliment
a cunt.
To the show. Oh, he's referencing TJ's thing.
Oh, okay.
The overexpository thing caused by his brain disorder.
Okay.
Anyways, so let's see.
Whoa.
Am I the only one who wishes there could be more? I'm skipping down. Am I the only one who wishes there could be more Share Dad? That was a little character I did a few episodes ago.
Share Dad? I don't remember that.
What does this even mean? I don't even know what's happening.
Well, I hope our listeners understand.
Yeah, believe me, Jackie. People who listen to the show are going to know what this means.
Yeah.
Okay. I know you don't remember. Frankly, I know I don't remember either.
I don't remember yesterday, ladies and gentlemen.
After Justin joked about Ryan and Jackie having kids, little boop boops, I was wondering what kind of characteristics these theoretical children would have in an alternate reality. Justin,
Down
syndrome.
No. They would, well, maybe. They'd be very affectionate.
Aww.
They would look lovingly into your eyes. Mm-hmm. They'd sort of lick your mouth affectionately.
If Jackie and I mated, what would our kids be like?
Like that, little boop boops.
So little boop boops, they'd have Down syndrome and lick our faces.
No. They wouldn't have Down syndrome, Jackie.
Uh-huh.
They'd be very, very affectionate. They'd be sort of very strong personalities. They'd run around and kind of lick your lips, kind of look into your eyes and put their right paw up to sort of be
How
like,
old would
hello.
They be at this point?
20.
Like 12, 13. Uh-huh. They'd just be discovering masturbation, so that's a whole other thing. They'd be beating off and coming everywhere.
Okay,
you would find cum all over your
next
food.
Email.
Jackie, what are we going to do about these? About our kids?
We're not having kids. Next email.
This is an alternate reality.
Jackie,
I already said what they were going to be.
Uh-huh.
You might have kids that are I'm describing.
If they're Down syndrome, they're going to just be doing it in public.
Yeah.
We're going to have to deal with this.
Jackie.
At a bar mitzvah.
No.
At a wedding, at McDonald's, in line.
At a confirmation.
How are we going to discipline our kids, Jackie? They're beating off right behind the wedding
cake. At a fucking Aaron Brothers art store, wherever we are.
Jackie, what
the
are we going to say?
They're going to be like licking your mouth and coming on your shoes.
Can we read the next email or I'm going to leave? I have a lot of work to do.
Fine.
I'm not
next,
joking
next
you.
Email. Let's
I'm getting anxious.
Hey, let's not push our luck, Ryan.
No. Yep.
Next email, baby. Here we go.
Okay, anyways, thank you very much for your apology, Greg.
Unnecessary, but
warranted.
All right. Come on.
Okay, Fletch writes, "Dear Jackie."
Remember me, Jackie, from the movie
I'm
Fletch?
I'm listening.
"Dear Jackie, something happened tonight that made me think of you. I was in the kitchen with my roommate, and he stuck his finger in his nose, and then I saw him lick his finger.
Ew, God.
Basically, I saw him eat his boogers.
Ew!
Not only that, but this guy's always trying to hook up with me when he's drunk."
Wait, is this a girl or a guy?
So it's a girl who lives with a boy roommate.
Parenthetical, we're both gay.
Okay.
It's cool, guys. Dude.
Okay, keep going.
And while we're not in the relationship, don't you think it's kind of like farting in front of your partner? I mean, he's trying to seduce me, but then he picks his nose.
Wait,
I have different things about that.
Hold on. Do you think eating a booger is worse than farting in front?
Yes. That's like...
Really?
Yeah. That's
you
not
wouldn't
cool.
do that in front of a guy?
No. I would never do that.
Why? What's the difference?
When I'm by myself.
No, there's
it's
something
less gross in a
no,
way.
No. I don't know. There's something completely different about that. Like booger picking and eating, like that's fucking gross.
Yeah.
But like the funk, like poops and farts. It's just different to
Jackie,
me. I don't know.
That's fucking more gross than booger eating.
No. Someone makes their boogers. It's just like this gross. Like, yeah. That reminds me of the elementary school kid who saved his boogers in his lunchbox and ate them for snacks later. Like, there's something wrong with you. If you eat your booger, if you're old and you eat your boogers. And I don't want to see that. I don't think that's
okay. Yeah. Fine.
That's gross.
You win this round, Jackie.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it makes sense because farting is just a noise.
It's just silly. But
I
booger
mean,
picking
eating
is
a booger
gross.
Is really committing to it.
Oh,
we have
no.
a guest. Hello. Is this going to be the suitcase full of Deutschmarks? No. Is it going to be
okay? Who is
the farting
it?
Farting Nazi? Who could it be?
Hello.
Oh,
it's
Mario.
Mario.
Mario, welcome.
I just don't want to say that I pick up my nose and a Luigi, he say, oh, it's not a good, you shouldn't do that. But then I say, well, you know, I have a thing in my nose and I want to get it out.
Uh-huh. Jackie, what do you think of that?
I'm just a human.
You know, Mario, Jackie,
I'm, just a
I'm
human.
Sorry. You're not a human, first of all. Jackie has a lot of work to do.
I'm
you
a
know,
pixel.
Usually I suffer you well.
I'm a pixel.
I'm a fan.
I'm a just a pixel.
Yeah, but Jackie has a lot of work to get to tonight, so yeah, I'm going to have to... I can't indulge you on this.
Okay.
What? What?
Just let me sit.
Okay.
In the corner.
Jackie,
okay,
spread your legs.
Okay, come sit down. All right.
Okay.
Come sit down.
Okay. Keep this a mic. Microphone.
Live?
But, yes.
Okay.
I have things.
So in case you want to say anything.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Nuzzle into Jackie's mom's pubis. Okay, anyways, he goes on to say, I'm not a farting advocate, but I was kind of on your side against Justin and Ryan. However, I draw the line of booger eating. What's
yeah.
your opinion? Blah, 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 blah.
I draw the line, too.
By the way, Karen Winters is beautiful.
Oh.
I've been listening to Tan Guy all week long.
I know. I'll have to bring that in the next podcast.
Oh, actually, you know what? Actually, we need to make a whole segment, Jackie, about your musical past.
Okay. Yeah,
and
that'd be fun.
Scene.
It'll be great. Okay.
Yeah, it'll be funny.
And we will, ladies and gentlemen, next episode or the one after that. I don't know.
I was listening to Tan Guy. I like that song.
I like
Damn,
it.
Yeah.
I like it, baby. Yeah. Not the original, but the one you did for Cartoon Network.
Oh, I love favorite. The original one better.
I don't know. It's a little rough.
What?
That's a little rough.
No. Well, that's a rough recording.
Very
it's a little rough.
Voice,
no,
Jackie.
I do not have a beautiful
you
voice.
No,
beautiful.
You do.
Horrible.
Yeah, you have a beautiful voice.
That is not. Beautiful. That's not the. That's a joke. That's not real.
No. I felt it was sincere.
Shut up,
Ryan. Oh, Mario's trying to sing.
She have. No, okay voice.
Oh, Mario.
It's not, I do not
I
have
just,
a good singing voice.
She just to have, in a Mushroom Kingdom,
uh-huh.
she'd be, you know, like a 5 out of 10.
And Mushroom Kingdom Idol?
Yeah.
That's the joke of it, is that I can't sing.
Jackie, you'll be all right.
All right, let's
go.
If
it's a joke, I don't think it's funny.
Can we read the email from the guy who's going to make a Grandma's
please,
Virginity
God.
Reference in a video game? Can
Subject,
we please?
We all know you like balls. So I just okay. have to, this is from Ryan.
Oh,
so
bro.
I just have to, one simple question. What soundbar do you guys use? If it's an app, could you please tell me the name?
No, never. I'll
Love
never give my secrets.
Nope.
I'm mighty pirate.
Gunner writes,
face.
Subject
Gunner.
Line, ooh, he gave us another listener art. Ooh, from Norway, Jack.
Love Gunner.
Wait, did he really give us listener
yeah.
art?
Yeah.
Hey, by the way.
Darren sent one. Did you guys see that one?
Oh, my God.
I died
Hold
when
on.
I saw it.
Well, that's not
oh
going to be
God,
for the
that
next.
Was amazing.
We're yes. not going to be able to
I
use
know.
That
okay.
until
oh,
next.
Oh, sorry.
Let's,
She's so talented.
How did you see that?
She
how
sent
did...
it to me because she knows that I don't pay
Dude,
attention
it
to
is
the.
So good.
Yeah.
Oh,
That'll be episode like
this episode. We're using the episode art.
Gunner.
No.
Tyler?
No.
No.
Nico.
Okay. That's right.
I didn't see that.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Great. We've been getting some amazing
We've been getting like
art. Did you see
good.
Chris Pierre's new one? The human
oh
centipede one?
Oh my god,
one?
Yeah, it's
oh,
so
dude.
Good.
I mean, I can't believe it.
We have episode art for
it's
the
an
next 4 episodes.
Riches.
It's and they're all like fucking awesome.
Are these all on Facebook?
No. I don't put them up on Facebook until
oh, okay.
we've
so
already
Okay, so that's why I haven't
them.
Seen
yeah,
them.
Yeah. And by the way, don't stop you guys from doing episode art. Just
oh, please, yeah, please, like
I
keep
love
them
it.
Coming
I
because
love
like
it.
By the way, they're getting like people are getting like they're taking like, they're not just doing us through, they're kind of doing like scenes and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's so good. It's yeah. so fucking cool. Like, we're getting just really awesome pieces of art that are great.
Jackie, here's a question.
And the last
from
few
Gunner?
Have been great.
Yeah.
Okay.
If given the choice, would you prefer A, getting a fish hook pierce your eye every Thursday at noon? No serious damage to the eye, though. Or B,
my cock fucking your ass.
Or B, twisting your ankle every step you take every day.
Jesus.
Oh, I'd pick ankle stuff. I can't handle anything with my eye. I had a paper cut once in my eye.
Oh, really?
Yep, with a manila envelope. I'd pick the ankle.
All right.
All right, well, good for you then, I guess.
Certainly.
Yeah, bitch.
Interesting.
Gunner, send a picture.
This
of your penis.
This subject is, this email says subject, Grandma's Virginity in a fucking video game.
Oh.
Dear Justin Ryan and the rest. Jackie and Prentice.
He couldn't
of course.
Remember my
yeah.
name.
Yeah, no. He likes you. He's just being a, he's being a teen.
Anyways, yeah, he said that he moved from Ohio to Southern California for his career, and he left his loved ones and his friends and his girlfriend behind.
Mm-hmm.
And as a part of his new friendless, empty existence, he's been listening to our podcast.
Oh, wow.
So many people preface it that way, like mm-hmm. why they listen to GVP.
Yeah.
I don't have any friends, and
left.
I have nothing left.
Yeah.
I eat turds and buttholes. Mm-hmm.
So anyways, he's managed to catch up on some episodes,
okay.
and it says that it's brought much joy to his life and brought a partial delay to his inevitable suicide.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, and so he figures it's time to pay it forward.
It's speeding up mine.
So he's been rewriting the translated text of a Japanese video game into something a little more palatable for the English-speaking brain mind, and he knows that Justin and I, although not
no,
really
not
me,
Ryan, just
but Justin enjoys video games, and he figures he'd show his gratitude by immortalizing the Grandma's Virginity podcast in an Honest to God video game.
Okay, now can I just say really quick a little insight to the audience? I am so anally obsessed with video games that I read this
you stick
email.
Controllers up your ass is what you're saying.
Yeah, I literally stick my control every controller and Nintendo handheld and Sony handheld up my ass.
Okay,
no. I read this email, and I knew immediately what video game company he worked for.
Okay.
And I responded, and I said, do you work for... blah, 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 blah. And he said... he wrote back, and he's like, how the fuck did you know that?
Yeah.
So... and it's good. It's great. So, ladies and gentlemen of the Grandma's Virginity podcast listening audience...
there'll be a video game out soon.
What reference should he
make.
Include...
He's going to translate a Japanese video game into English, and he's going to throw in some sort of subtle reference in
yes.
the English translation to Grandma
and
Virginity.
Please understand that this game will be available
for PS3,
in a store.
Xbox
360. Well, no, we don't know. It's definitely...
Nintendo DS, Nintendo 3DS.
It very well could be,
oh,
yes. It very well could
be.
No,
it on,
absolutely.
Of,
it's a translated game. It will be available on a console. It will be available in the stores. And when we find out what it is, we will tell you all to buy it and play through it and try to find the reference. But should it be a pigs or people thing? Should it be a psychic abilities?
Should it be a Jackie having sex with her father reference?
Shut up!
Sorry.
Come on. Gross!
Should it be a reference to Mario? That may kind of be like an echo chamber.
Should it be... excuse me.
Yeah, go ahead, Mario.
I think... You should have told him to say something... about me and my brother Luigi, because of Luigi, he taken my
to go.
He taken my piggy
Jackie.
Bank.
I'm not joking you.
I keep
just kind of gently grind against my back.
I save him a money because I want to buy a plane a ticket.
Oh.
And a Luigi.
Oh, Mario.
Are you taking my piggy bank?
Are you getting wet, Jackie?
No,
because of
getting
Mario's
ready
tears?
To go.
Okay,
I'm
wait.
Ready to go.
Mario, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Okay, all right. Just a reference to that.
Okay. Okay, hello. This is from Alejandra. Hey, you guys. My name is Alejandra. I just want to say you guys are awesome and you better keep doing the show.
How old are you?
Until you guys are on the brink of death.
Are you legal?
I guess. Take care.
Oh, wow. Okay, that was quick.
Cute.
Next email.
Okay, almost done, Jackie.
Okay, good.
Girl. This is subject, Grandma's Virginity, love the show. Hi, I'm Kevin from Arizona, and I'm 14.
Cute.
And just want to say I love the show. I love Jackie's love of shits and farts. And
my cock is hard, and I'm ready to fuck Jackie.
But I have to say that I'm with Justin and Ryan about not farting from your girlfriend. Okay, everybody.
Wait, hold on, Kevin. Wait, can I just ask Kevin a question? Mm-hmm. Kevin, write us back. I won't remember what it's in reference to. I'll have no idea what you're talking about when you respond, but... if Jackie came up to you and said, I will fucking suck your cock.
Oh, God.
and let you fuck me if you're cool with me farting all over you and shitting in your mouth. Would you do it? Yeah, you would. Because you're 14, you little faggot.
Okay, Justin.
Sorry.
Four Loko.
I'm out of control. You know, your grandfather inspired me. He's 89 years old, and he's drinking like a goddamn sailor. Uh-huh. And I'm like, well, fuck it. I'm going to be 31 tomorrow. Uh-huh. Literally tomorrow. I'm going to be 31. Happy fuck birthday. It. I can drink like him. And I can't keep up with him.
He's
I'm
kind
away.
Of not, like, he doesn't represent, like, oh, if you just live well and live healthy, you'll be 90.
No, what does he represent?
He's like, drink and get a lot of ladies. Yeah.
He represents either good genetics or he stayed away from microwaves. I don't know what the fuck he did, but somehow he managed to beat the system.
Okay. It's Charlie again.
Charlie Loken.
Charlie Wang?
Charlie, yes. Not Charlie Wang. Charlie Loken.
Charlie right. Wang is doing good. In he reference, emailed me.
Yeah. Oh, did he really? Yeah. He has an email.
You know, why doesn't he
apartment.
Email the fucking show, Charlie Wang?
Yeah.
He has his own apartment.
What?
I can come visit anytime I want.
In China?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh, China. Love. You come to China.
Tell me what Charlie Loken wrote.
Is that his
hey, me Chinese. Me play trick. Me put cocoa in your...
Dick?
I fucked it up.
Okay, go.
Okay. In reference to Justin thinking I'm a poacher, it's not poaching unless you don't have a license, and I do.
And I sometimes don't.
It is illegal, however, to shoot from the road. You're right, Justin.
Yeah.
Which
okay.
sometimes we do.
Oh.
For Jackie, the only thing I've
poaching.
Ever killed is deer, and the only taxidermy-related things I've done with any of the animals is the European mount, and you don't know want to know what that is.
Aw, Charlie Loken.
Which is where you keep the
Charlie,
skull.
Oh, Charlie, you're lovable, even though you kill animals
the
from the road.
The skull and the antlers?
Yeah, that whole thing.
I have that. I have a deer of that. I'll take a picture.
Yeah, and you get rid of all the skin.
Fucking make me sick.
By the way, I was just joking. I didn't forget to attach a picture of my penis. I never intended to. But, Jackie, you sounded very eager to see it.
No! No!
Yeah, she was, dude.
No, I was not.
Hey, Charlie, after we stopped recording, she was just asking
Mario, do you feel a wet spot
so
against
young.
Your back? Do you feel a wet spot against your back?
Would you shut up? I'm leaving.
How you feel in my
I'm
back?
I'm leaving. Bye.
It's a
sorry. Also, Jackie, I don't know why I didn't think to ask
Jackie!
You before. I remember while watching SpongeBob, I used to notice a few sexual innuendos in here and there. I think he's confused.
He's asking about SpongeBob. She was on it. So.
Oh, you were?
No, I was a PA.
She worked on it, yeah.
PA,
tell the truth. Were those sexual innuendos intentional?
Sure.
Ken Osborne was behind those, wasn't
Dude,
he?
Fuck
no,
yeah, they were.
Everybody.
Listen, I could ask anybody in animation and they'll tell you that if you spot a possible
innuendo?
Sexual
yeah,
innuendo,
it
that
is.
It is. And that it somehow squeaked
It's all the
past
sickest people in
the
world. The S&P
are in department.
Animation.
Yeah.
Well, one last thing. Justin, I can tell that the relationship you're in right now is different than any other you've had, and I'm worried that you're going to go and get married and leave GVP in the dust. Please tell me I'm wrong.
You're wrong in that I won't leave GVP
but
in the dust.
You'll get married.
But I might
Wedding
get married.
Bells.
Hello.
In like, you know, another 6 months or
oh,
a year.
Oh, boy. 6 months to a year.
Whoa,
Jesus.
That's soon.
Well, you know, I've always said 3 years before you pop the question, but, you know, I'm thinking
Whoa,
maybe.
If she listens to this, she's going to be expecting
she'll,
an engagement
she'll
ring soon.
She'll never hear this.
Then why didn't you ask my grandfather about advice for women? You got all clammed up about that. Like, because you thought Margaret was going to listen.
Well, no, because it was a whole different thing. I don't know.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Can we bring him back? I think you would have been like, let me tell you something.
Yeah, of course.
I was balls deep in Charlie McGraw.
Of course he would have. Yeah. He doesn't take bullshit.
I was balls deep.
I always want to be more like him, but I'm like, I can't. I'm too sensitive.
You know what, though? The guy, you'll never be. You will be like him when you're his age.
No, he was always like that. He was like banging chicks in fields when he was like 12 years old.
God
Go
damn
on.
It. But I really love this one. Ah, whatever.
This is from
Charlie. Is it Charlie?
Yeah,
I'm going to marry her, and I'm going to fucking leave you in the dust.
This is from Andrew. No
Poacher.
Subject. Jackie, so when can we go to Germany? Fuck money. I'm sorry. So Jackie, so when can we go to Germany? Fuck Norway. There are a bunch of fags there, worse than Canadians, and they're bad. Skadoosh, Justin Ryan, hi.
Wait, is Andrew
Wait, who is
German?
This guy?
Yeah, no.
Oh, is he the one that wrote Dirty Things?
Yeah.
I love him.
Who is it?
Right, so when seriously, when are you going to go to Germany?
I want
to
go.
With him?
Wait, he's in
but
Germany?
He lives in Germany? Or I don't know.
I think he lives in Germany.
I think does he live in fucking Bakersfield?
Like, yeah. Oh, right.
Dude, fuck you, dude.
You have to live in Berlin for me to come visit you.
Go suck
go
a dick.
Go live in Berlin and then I'll come.
All right.
Okay.
But name, don't stop listening to the show.
Subject yeah. line, name drop. Hey, guys, it's been forever since I thought about you. No offense. Anyway, just listen to The Nerdist, episode 62. The Nerdist is a podcast.
Yeah, Chris Hardwick, Jonah Ray,
with our friend Jonah
and
Ray.
A bunch of other people I don't know.
Yeah, we know Jonah Ray. It's safe to say.
Yeah, I love Jonah Ray.
Yeah,
great.
We're friends with him.
Don't know who that is. Go on.
If you'd have come to the party, Justin's last week, and you would
what
have
party?
Him.
Oh,
yeah,
I was
the
crying.
Party that you were in your fucking crazy nincompoop nonsense. Yeah.
Anyways, at the very beginning of Nerdist 60, episode 62, Justin's name was dropped, and your podcast mentioned.
Yeah,
wow.
They mentioned the show.
I was super excited for you guys. You should send a thank you card. Justin, yeah. Did write a thank you email.
Well, I'm going to write a thank you card and say thank you for mentioning us. All right, so I already wrote Jonah.
Very good, Justin.
It okay. made my day.
Okay. I also wanted to let you know that I've been using a lot of Jackie's quotes lately, especially aww. Daddy.
Oh, good.
And no one gets it, but I laugh hysterically every time. I still love you guys, and I really hope this little break isn't the beginning of a terrible divorce.
No.
Well, guess what, everybody? We plan on doing this from now on every week.
Yeah.
Well, hold on.
Oh, I thought it was every other
every
week.
Every week.
Every Sunday?
Every Sunday.
Yeah, every Sunday. Hold on to your shorties. We're gonna try our best,
but we're gonna be more organized.
But we
Jackie.
Do have really great guest books.
Yeah, we've got some guests.
Thanks
lined
to
up.
Our producers, Dean Pelton and Sam Lembeck.
We're trying to get our shizzy together,
mm-hmm.
and those guys are really keeping us in check.
Anyway,
and that's what we need. We need them to just kick us around and punch us in the throat.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Because guess what? We're in the industry of no profit, no point, no future,
no love.
Yeah, no love.
That was
four,
from Jade.
Four things.
Cute.
Okay. Jade.
Okay, keep going.
Jade?
Last email.
Let's do it.
Last
love,
email.
Love you guys. My name is Lynn.
Ashley is Cooper.
Oh,
she's
I've
what?
I've been listening to you guys for a while now at work and love getting the strange looks when I bust out laughing and no one around me knows what is so funny. I'm a little behind, but I just listened to episode 19, which I have to say has been the best so far. I believe that was the episode with Chris Romano.
Oh, really?
Right, right, right.
Jackie wants to come back.
Yeah, I love him.
Well, he'll come back eventually.
So
maybe we'll
much.
Get some action.
Maybe
going.
We'll get him and
my grandfather.
That'd be awesome. Oh my god.
Yeah, I was gonna say
we should do
Eric
that. We should
Stoppner,
do like
but...
mashups. Like, hey, yeah, yeah. What if this guest
hey,
and this guest?
Hello.
Yeah.
No.
That would be pretty. Come on. That'd be pretty funny.
Fuck no.
That'd be. Come on.
Fuck you.
Psychic abilities in Mario, sorry Jackie, makes me LOL more than the rest of the characters.
I like psychic abilities.
But I think they're all great. So glad Charlie Wayne came back, was worried about him. And I think Mr. Scoops is on a major drug run in South America. Mm-hmm. You should take up a collection for bail money.
Well, he's back now, girlfriend.
Girlfriend.
You're a little behind, Scoopy Noops.
Hope he returns soon. He did, safely, he did. I want more pigs or people. You guys help make my 50-hour work
week
bearable.
Yeah, we do
bearable.
Need a new...
For the
pigs
record, I'm married, 31-year-old mom of two from
wow.
North Carolina.
Hello.
Up. So probably not your typical listener. Keep
I'm
good
sure
work.
She's gorgeous, though.
And by
come
the
on.
Way, I've gotten at least three of my friends on board listening to you as well.
Oh, thank you.
Yay.
You know what? Good for you. We need a pledge drive for
yeah.
how many friends have you gotten to
yeah.
listen?
Not money. Listeners.
Yeah, just listeners.
Yeah.
And you idea. Call us. Like, oh, we just... found out we've yeah. got two new listeners. The yeah. number will
get Jack
go up.
Nicholson.
Yeah. Yeah, Jack Nicholson will be here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Natalie
De Niro.
Portman, Robert yeah. De Niro. Yeah,
sit on my face.
Bill Cosby.
Yeah, and
he'll
what, they'll be answering phones and being
no,
like,
they'll just be performing.
I just got a new listener.
No, they'll be performing, and then in the background
hey,
there'll
Justin,
be a bank of.
I'm on the phone with Lynn
oh,
from North Carolina.
Oh my God, it's the guy
Jack
from
Nicholson?
The Shining. Yeah, Jack
yeah.
Nicholson.
She says that she got three of her friends, their soccer
when
moms.
When he was doing the
PTA.
Pledge drive
wow,
for,
amazing.
When he was doing the pledge for 9/11, you know, when 9/11 happened, they raised all that money.
Terrible
I just remember
tragedy.
It cutting into him on the phone going like this. There's a place for us. He was singing West Side Story song to some listener that pledged
shut
a lot of money.
What?
Jack Nicholson was singing
all
somewhere.
Right.
Can we get Jack Nicholson on the show? As a
oh,
guest?
Yeah, yeah, tomorrow.
God,
tomorrow.
That'd be the best.
Tomorrow.
All right.
Wouldn't that be the best?
Yeah, tell me everything you know, Jackie Nicholson.
Jack, give me a good story.
Yo, Jackie, tell me what you know, Jackal.
All right, bye.
Oh, wait. Let's do this properly.
Okay.
Let's do a proper dismount.
Okay.
All right, everybody.
That was
thank
episode
you.
27.
Yeah.
In your mouth.
Multiple generations.
Listen, it might go down in history as our worst episode ever.
Why would you say
best.
That?
You know, I'm just anticipating.
Why you didn't think the interview went well?
hold on. Let me get the reverse. It might go down in history as our best episode ever, depending on how you look at it.
Yeah, it's all
you can hear both of those and decide which one you want to be a part of and text it to 1473. No, but seriously, email your things to grandmasvirginity@gmail.com.
Continue sending in contest entries. You win a Nintendo 3DS.
Yeah, seriously, I swear to fucking God, we've got a lot of good entries, but come on, motherfuckers! What are you people doing? Send your fuck. Okay, hold on. The fact of the matter is this. We've got a Nintendo 3DS as first prize. We've got original art that was used in Mr. Sprinkles in a beautiful, expensive frame.
Who cares?
Professionally framed.
The VH1 show.
Signed by me, Mike Chillian, and Dan Harmon. That's a huge prize. That should be first prize.
Okay!
Third prize is you can fuck Jackie Buscarino in her asshole and vagina.
Would you stop it?
Even if you're a girl, you put a strap-on on. No, Jackie.
I'm leaving now. I have to go. This is getting crazy.
Okay,
bye,
but anyway.
Is it? Bye.
Is it talking about how contrast?
I'm sort of kidding about the third prize, but anyway.
Winner could have anal
right,
sex.
So,
that's
hold
crazy.
On. All keep,
right.
Keep.
There she goes. There she goes.
All right.
There she goes again.
Jesus Christ. What do we hit? Email us.
Picture
follow
people.
Us on Twitter. Picturepeople.com. Picturepeople.com. Facebook page. Tell your friends about us.
Farting and pooping.
No.
We don't want any more of that.
Don't be absent-minded.
Look both
in
ways.
Your own life.
The street.
Remember to focus on the now.
Yeah.
And not the past or the future.
I think that Mario needs to. Mario?
Yeah, yes.
I think that your problem is that you don't believe in now.
I worry.
What do you worry about, Mario? What do you worry about, Mario? Look at me.
I think it's sometimes when I look, or when I get up, I think about where will I be in 2 years.
You don't think about what you'll be in 2 years. You think about what you'll be at this moment. It's the only thing there is. All there is right now is level 3, world 2.
And sometimes I think about level 3, world 3.
No, you think about level 3, world 2.
All right, okay. All right, everybody. Hello. Here we go.
More of that. Tell your friends. They can get plenty of that.
Oh, geez. That's the sharpest comedy you've ever heard coming out of this show. All right. Seriously, though. Rate us on iTunes. Seriously. Somebody fucking give us a good rating on iTunes. What are we doing here?
What are we doing?
Have we hit a fucking... Have we hit
right,
a wall?
Let's wrap it up, Justin.
Okay. All right.
Love you.
Thank you to Dean Pelton and Sam
Lembeck.
Thank you
to my grandfather.
And also
Bert
thank
Gladstone
you to Ryan
for
Elder
for saving the world and killing Hitler.
Thank you to Ryan Elder.
Oh.
The unspoken hero of the show. Thank
yeah,
you to our
he made
announcer.
Some music.
Thank you to Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, yeah. who is coming back momentarily, just in a couple of weeks.
Thank you to my uncle for driving my grandfather.
And thank you to Mr. Noobs.
All right.
Who you'll meet next week.
Peace out.
Hey, that was a great show. I respect the Army, don't you? They have guns, you know. Seriously. Send your emails, episode art, and other treasures to grandmasvirginity@gmail.com. The Nintendo 3DS contest is real, people. Start spamming your favorite game blog to cover the story on their website. We're giving away a freaking 3DS, people. I've seen worse news stories on a good day. Download our 3DS contest episode for all the rules. Rate us on iTunes, follow us on Twitter @GrandsVirginity, and join in our Facebook fun at www.pigsarepeople.com. While you're there, like my Facebook page, facebook.com/bigvoiceoverfun. I'm your announcer, Smith Harrison. Go do something nice for someone this week. Say a kind word or give a homeless person some money. I don't know. Or speaking of armies, how about the Salvation One? Go chunk some gold in their bucket. Something. Just do something good for someone in need. Stop thinking about yourself all the time. Thanks for listening. We'll see you on the flip side. Tumbly Boots.